Hello, my name is Patrick Coleman, and I am a shaman in Chicago, Illinois, and I've been working with this 14-year-old boy.
Do not diddle kids, it's no good diddling kids.
Which is probably illegal, so arrest me. Go on.
Do I look suspicious?
Do you like nipples?
Fuck yeah.
Do you like retarded internet stuff?
Yes, please. I wish to be a part of fart male white porn.
Do you like consuming large amounts of alcohol and drugs? Do you want to get fucked in the ass in the astral realm?
Yeah, I want 10 dicks in my asshole.
Then you've come to the right place. Welcome to Ronaldo the Nipple Lord's channel, where you will get to witness all of these amazing things and more.
Tune in weekly
for Ronaldo as he meets with YouTube's top minds in a roundtable discussion of all things truly important, such delicate matters as cake farts, fart slash semen slash urine transference, cat molestation, relationship advice, and of course, Ronaldo's milky nipples, which secrete the true nature of the gods. He is known in his homeland as Ronaldinho, the milking saint. And of course, it is rumored that staring deep into one of his nipples triggers ultimate enlightenment of the gods. Your third eye will shit itself with blissful joy.
My bad.
And you will go forth as a new person, washed pure in the milk of Ronaldo the Nipple Lord.
Subscribe today!
The third eye will thank you.
You feel the healing energy of this place all around you. Now find your power, Adam.
Thank you.
power at.
This is just a kudos video to Mike Thompson, otherwise known as Ami Harris. This guy is incredibly brilliant, incredibly witty, and we have a common enemy, the flat earthers. You know, obviously we had our little disagreements in the past, but I don't know, just coming to like this guy. I mean, not in a gay way. I'm not gay or anything, but this guy is really up-and-coming talent. I really think that you guys should check him out. And, like I said, I can see being friends with this guy one day. Once he understands that I am really Lord and Concave Earth is reality. So.
Truth is, I actually do believe in Lord Stephen Christ, and I'm just making these videos in order to help perpetuate his will.
Baby, you've got the cutest personality.
We're gonna have a vampire party tonight. We're gonna have a vampire party, alright! Cause we ain't got nothing better to do than stab vampires and drink a couple of brews. Conspiracy swords!
And get shamans!
Psychic vampires!
And all those noobs!
Cause we ain't got nothing better to do than stab vampires and drink a couple of brews. Yeah!
No.
Yes, motherfucker.
That's the most horrible song that I've ever heard in my life. So bad.
Me too. I agree.
You ruined the intro with your intro song.
Well, that's as good as it's going to get, goddammit.
Yeah, I'm not going to try any harder to do any better.
No, not at all.
What a shock. So how's it going? Right. How's it going, guys?
Pretty goddamn good. Pretty goddamn good. Had an interesting week, didn't we, guys?
That's a lovely hat. I just noticed it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, that's our merchandise on the Astral Realm.
How many Astral dollars does that cost?
That's 4 Astral blowjobs.
Oh.
Gotta give us that's Ooh. Each. So it's gonna
I like hats. I just don't need to do that right now.
You wouldn't give an astral BJ?
I'm all done on the astral realm right now, but in the right circumstances with the right lighting, probably.
And the right guy.
So, you know.
Come on.
CW Chanter. What if it was CW?
Well, he does spend a lot of time on the astral realm, what with the religion and whatnot.
You know, he probably wouldn't want a BJ from you anyway, since you're not a cat, so it seems doubtful.
Speaking of cats, we also got these t-shirts on the Astral store, Hug Life.
Oh,
this is to protect the cats from certain people.
Save the kitties.
This money goes straight to that, so, like, I mean, it's going to go to a good cause.
Yeah. Actually, it's a front. This is part of a big, giant cat raping ring.
Scientologist one at that. Hill Hubbard.
We just buy cats for Scientologists, and then we ship them off, and that's the last we ever see of them, but I'm pretty sure they're raped to death by CW Chanter. What facility do they do that at? Somebody save this joke. Come on.
I don't know what facility. His rape dungeon, his cat rape dungeon in his basement and his garage. I don't know.
I don't know. Make something up. Cloning center. Yeah. There you go.
I don't know. How about this? CW Chanter clones cats in his basement so he can fuck them to death. That was hilarious.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure
somebody give me that. A job writing for Stephen Colbert. That was hilarious.
Yeah. Right this moment.
Yeah. It's more like John Oliver, to be honest.
Yeah, he sucks. I don't really. I want to shoot higher than that. So.
Yeah, John Oliver does kind of suck. I will say that.
He's terrible.
Yeah.
He likes reiterating that it's 2016.
But we have had an interesting week.
Oh, yes.
Oh, sure.
So interesting.
What brought us into this dead end?
Yeah, there's so much to talk about that we're not going to talk about. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really hard, though. God, I won't talk about it. Greg, yeah, don't worry.
Don't worry, Greg.
Yeah, shut up, Greg. Just shut your mouth.
Bastard.
What do you guys want to do you want to commence Chanter Watch? Because I hear CW Chanter has been manifesting in various places around the world. He's finally developing his powers.
That's right. He can be in multiple locations any one time, so it's important that the world knows about this.
That's so very true.
If you spot CW, wherever you are, you know, just if it's a cool thing to do, send us in a photograph. Don't do anything stupid, but we're interested in knowing where he's manifesting. And yep. It's because we love him and we want to be closer to him.
I know. I've been giving this Commonwealth chanting thing some thought, and it actually it makes a lot of sense, you know? Who knows? Who knew?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Now,
you know.
Now, guys, listen. I just wanted to apologize, okay, in person. I'm really, really sorry. I never meant any of it. The curse is lifted. I don't know why my nose is in my mouth, but guys, please, please, please. Just forgive me. I'm really sorry. I never meant to bother you, Dwindle.
You know, Kay is going to send, or Carlos is going to send Kay to disembowel you and have you replaced with a clone for stealing his shtick.
Well, I had $2 and it was at Walmart and I bought it, so.
It would be very hard not to buy something like that.
Give me $2 and I'll stop.
Well, here's our first sighting from Chanter Watch. Remember, guys, hashtag Chanter Watch. Can you see it? Or is it all black?
It's all black.
Oh, god damn you fucking piece
of
shit.
I saw it for a second, and it went all black.
Tyler Durden effect.
Yeah.
Yeah, those little subliminal things, they do creep in. And as much as we try and steer away from them, it's going to happen.
Yeah, that's true. Just a little quick flash of a CW. Just a little quick flash of a CW.
So I do get
they never knew it was even there.
Oh, hello.
I'm sorry, it was the curse of the Chanter. Threw me off.
No, the curse is gone, man.
It's gone.
You're going to have to like come up with something new now.
The curse can... I really don't think the curse should be gone yet. I think it needs to play out for a few more weeks at least.
Could be a little bit more cursed, please.
Yeah, there needs to be more.
That tit's a little still fat. We can milk some more out of it.
Yeah, there's a lot of milk in them there, titties. All right, I'm just going to show you on... there's a lot of milk. Cats like milk, too. I'll just show you in paint. Oh, great. Oh, God, I hate hangouts. I hate you, hangouts. Suck my dick. There you go. Can you see it now? The first sighting of CW Chanter since the beginning of Chanter Watch, everyone. The timing is great on this joke, everyone. It was totally perfect.
Yeah, it's not over-ramped even slightly.
Nope. Everything went together exactly how the gods determined it would for this joke.
As it, yeah.
Anybody want to like make cat raping jokes while we're still on this?
Yeah, no, this is just too dead.
Yeah.
No cat rape jokes come to me immediately.
Yeah.
I think, you know.
Look, a cat rape.
He's never really into that thing, really.
Well, how do you know if you haven't tried it?
No, I mean, the discussion, the cat thing, that's your thing. It's not my thing.
Oh, you're disassociating from that because you're afraid of the way it makes you look, huh?
Yeah.
No.
You don't want to save the cats?
Own cats' throats matter, okay? We're all a part of this. Don't try to back out now that me and Ron are in the line of fire about this.
Yeah, you're right. You're absolutely correct.
Stand up for your principles of not raping cats.
Look, I understand that cats, that all throats matter, but cats are a minority that have been oppressed for too long, and it's about time we started paying attention to this atrocity.
All throats matter.
Hashtag cats throats matter, guys.
Cats throats matter most.
I'm converted.
I have a question. Are you backing down because CW got to you somehow?
Dun, dun, dun.
Has he been communicating with you privately and making any kinds of threats or anything that we should know about? Because we can help you. If CW is coming after you, we know people who can help you.
Are we talking about the special people?
Yeah. I'll tell you what.
The paid agents?
Yeah. Anybody, really. He could send a magic cat to talk to you in your sleep. So. Yeah, he could do that. Listen, what I want you to do, if you're in trouble, can you just draw a heart on your hand?
And then, yeah.
We'll know.
Nice Marina Joyce reference there.
Yeah.
We need to pull some of that crazy bitch into this show.
Oh, I mean, she's crazy.
But we do have she's some psycho. Interesting, we've got some very interesting crazies tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Quite a spread, a good retard spread. For you people this evening.
You know, I was just thinking of that Marina Joyce joke because I just saw the video on Scare Theater talking about whether or not she's been kidnapped or is in an abusive relationship or something. Ron, you know a little bit about what's going on with Marina Joyce.
I don't know a whole lot about it. I just know basically, I guess, what's in that video too, because I think I saw that one. But she... started just acting kind of weird and doing these little key things people were picking up on and thinking that either she's on drugs, which I think is very likely. There's some other stuff that, you know, like she's trying to hoax it for attention. People just kind of ran with it and made it more than, I don't know. I have no idea, really. She's a crazy fucking bitch, though. I will say that. Like, her eyes are just, like, bulging out of her head at all times. Her hands are, like, very puppet-like the way she moves. She's on something. I don't know what it is, but I don't want it.
Why not? I want it.
It doesn't look enjoyable.
It's good for her views.
Yeah.
It's always in the eyes, though, isn't it? And I noticed that with the with some of the Christian people I was looking at.
Yeah, crazy eyes is a real thing.
The full frontal stare, and it's unwavering most of the time, except when it's switching back and forward in a manic way.
Yeah. Yeah, you can always tell by looking in the fucking eyes. That's from because we all have psychic powers. So the eyes are the windows to the soul.
Her pupils are always fucking dilated. It's crazy.
I saw this video on Rainbot Horror's channel. There's like, it was a let's play, but it was a joke. And there was some game where it's like a point and click game where you're stuck in Marina Joyce's room. And you have to figure out what's going on. And, like, you can open the different drawers, but the windows are locked and everything. And she opens one of the drawers, and there's this huge dildo. Just...
I want to play that game, damn.
You got to check this video out. I was laughing my fucking ass off. I just dropped my phone. God, it's the curse of the chanter again. I know you guys said it's lifted, but I really don't. I still feel it in my balls.
You just like that whole, ooh, I'm threatened.
I do. I can't believe I've been threatened this way. Why won't the authorities step in? So
he said we're going to be dwindled.
Well, our watch time has dwindled, and our views have dwindled, and our annotation clicks have dwindled.
Why hasn't the police or YouTube done anything to stop this crazy madman?
I know. This is terrifying. I go to sleep at night scared that CW is going to come to me in a dream and turn me into a cat and have his way with me.
That may have already happened, though.
I think it did. Yeah, I had this weird dream, but I don't remember most of it. Just that, you know, CW's finger was down my throat. I think he has brown finger, too. It tasted really brown.
Oh, can I take that opportunity to...
Let's do it.
Thanks to one of the fans. This is Jona from Iceland, who's a talented makeup artist. And she made me a beautiful.
That finger on fleek. Look at that nail. Look at that beautiful nail.
That's like impressive detail too. Like it has like little like fingerprints on it and shit.
Yeah,
it does.
That's very nice. And
Yona was very thoughtful because Shaman fingers, you got to be careful.
You do, because he puts those fingers up plenty of assholes. So
gotta wear rondom. Gotta definitely wear your fucking rondoms, guys. Yeah.
I stole your line, Ron.
You fucking faggot. Thanks, I hate you.
Much appreciated.
Damn it.
Thank you. What'd you say your name was? Yona?
Yona from the Iceland fan base.
We know you're not really in Iceland. Come on.
Yeah, come on. You're in Canada, you fucking liar.
Yeah, you're in Canada.
I really am in Iceland.
He's from Quebec. Quebec.
Look, what kind of man in Iceland would wear a hat with Iceland on it?
Dumbass. You think we're going to fall for that?
The Doc Savage Owl of Wisdom with the shades. And there is a hat that goes with it, too.
Did she make you the owl because of that one video about that person whose name we're not going to mention having an owl in her video?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
It's detailed. Very appreciated.
Yeah.
That's very sweet. We love you guys. The fans are awesome.
Thank you, fans.
Yeah, I hate everyone, though. So, the more I love you, the more I want to kill you. How does that sound? That doesn't even sound like a joke, does it? It sounds very serious.
Sorry, you know, you've gone kind of dark lately. We've all seen it. Like,
true.
The vampirism is really starting to...
Dude,
get the hold of you.
I made a video calling Jimmy a registered sex offender with AIDS. No, never mind. Erase the last 10 seconds of this broadcast. Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, you've been doing a lot of darkness this week, you little bad boy. Bad boy.
God, I can't believe that I just...
Such bad boy.
Yeah, I feel really naughty right now. That was really... Let's move on.
I think the writer's muse needs to give you a spanking for that one.
There we go. There's a segue. How's that for a segue, everyone?
I know.
Hey, why don't we talk about the writer's muse?
And don't say the C word.
Wait a second. You mean cunt?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to say that. So, guys, I invited the writer's muse onto this broadcast, but of course we haven't heard anything because she doesn't ever reply to questions or invitations. So I guess she's not coming, but I want to reiterate, she's still invited. Hey, Amy.
Sounds to me like she's a big fat pussy.
Sounds like she has one. So Amy, I'm just saying, why don't you go ahead and reach out to someone in the chat or whatever. You can email me at omnieris@gmail.com. That's E-R-I-S. I'll get you a link, Amy. And you can bring on Patrick. Patrick, you're invited too, buddy. You always have an invitation, Patrick.
You guys can just come on here. We'll give you a platform to destroy us with your logic and your arguments and your evidence.
And you know what? I'll tell you what. If you guys think that you're outnumbered, you can not only invite a third person, but I haven't cleared this with Ron and Doc, but I'm going to go ahead and throw it out there. Why don't you invite a fourth person? Patrick, why don't you come on here with three of your buddies? Come on. Then you won't be outnumbered. Why don't you just do it? That's what we want.
Bring on that life coach guy. That'd be hilarious.
Bring on the life coach. What do all of Patrick's friends have in common? They all love Charles Manson. Times.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah, you guys have probably all interacted with the writer's muse if you've ever been on Patrick's channel. But one thing that she does not frequently advertise is her love for Charles Manson.
She's quite fond of him.
Yeah. Aside from her love for Patrick, I think her love for Charles Manson is maybe the most revealing thing about her.
Well, yeah, I would say you're right because it shows that she's willing to defend a fucking sick and deplorable person.
It shows what kind of guy she likes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
I think the other instructive thing is the absolute moratorium on answering a direct question.
Oh, yeah. She will not answer a single fucking question.
Yep. She dodges every single thing. I've seen Doc's comments to her, and he's laid it out very clear and concisely. Asked several questions. She won't reply to a single fucking one.
No.
She says that she's not on trial. And it's like, we have a fucking right to fucking say what we're saying, and then you want to pop up and tell us to not say what we're saying, but you won't provide any reason why.
We should just call her.
You're just bad boys. You need to stop it right now.
Well, I just think it's funny that in light of Patrick Butterfield's testimony, she comes out of the woodwork like the little fucking termite that she is and starts attacking Patrick Butterfield, says that he's lying, that he has every reason to lie. I mean, is he lying when he says he went into the relationship with money and came out with – you can say he's lying about whatever the fuck you want, but he went in with money and he came out fucking homeless. So – that alone is a
fucking panhandle.
You can't even deny, bitch. You can't even deny that that happened. What's your excuse for that? That he brought it on himself? Well, you know, in the same light, then Patrick has brought this scrutiny upon himself. So there you go.
If he's lying, I'll say this. He's a very fucking good liar, because when I very first messaged that guy, he was kind of freaking out whenever I asked him any questions about Patrick, that he thought I might be him trying to, like, catfish him somehow.
Well, we know what Patrick's capable of. Here's what we should ask ourselves, guys. Who's more likely to be the liar in this situation? Patrick John Coleman, who we've literally caught lying dozens of times and documented his various lies and changes to his story and attempts to manipulate? Or should we believe that Patrick Butterfield is lying? Who seems like the more obvious liar? The guy who is a notorious liar, or the guy who has absolutely no fucking reason to lie at all?
And let's not forget, we also had another ex-boyfriend that was on a week prior.
Don't
forget. Told us all kind of shit. Yeah, I guess they're lying too, even though their stories sound very similar.
And apparently Robin Eaglesong is also lying. They're all just fucking in this huge... They have nothing better to do, so one day they were like, why don't we betray this person who helped us all and was such a great inspiration in our life? Let's make up a huge conspiratorial story about him. And that's how this all happened, you fucking morons.
I mean, how could anybody make up some intricate shit like this?
No. You can't.
And, I have one additional comment. We certainly didn't make up the video record that Patrick left.
Yeah, and why does he delete videos? We don't delete our videos about Patrick.
With all the various heinous behavior that he documents and puts in on a public forum, as far as I'm concerned, commenting on that is a choice that we can make.
Of course.
And if people don't agree with what we do and why we do it, let's talk about it. But I won't tolerate threats. And if someone doesn't actually want to discuss and they just want to say that they have magical insight and not back it up with anything.
Yeah, she's a seer.
I've got better things to do with my time.
Well, all I know is I saw her saying, like, this ends tonight, Patrick. They won't come after you anymore. Of course, that was a week ago. Look at us now. But then that very night, she comes over to my channel and she goes, I, who, you, are. And then she says, fucking drunk. I'm like, really? That's the knife you're going to put in my throat? I mean... all of this talk about how you're going to put a stop to all of this tonight, and you come over and your fucking missile to launch at my face is that I'm a drunk.
I mean, hello, this is a guy that makes drunken 4 a.m. videos.
Yeah, dumbass. I don't give a shit what you think. And not to mention, Patrick's a fucking notorious substance abuser. So
yeah, he smokes meth, for fuck's sake. It's not like, just substances, but meth, guys. Like, holy shit.
It's like if I attack Hitler... and then some Nazi goes, yeah, but your country has the death penalty. It's like, who gives a shit? What's your fucking point?
That doesn't make that a good thing.
I had an interesting exchange earlier on that was actually quite and I actually enjoyed it. It was along similar lines to CW, as in, there are bigger fish to fry, there are people doing worse things and getting away with worse things, and I'm like, yeah, I couldn't agree more. But that doesn't make Patrick's medical advice any less dangerous.
I know.
And it doesn't make him a more credible individual. But I've stressed to people who are really critical that my interest, as I've said in a video, is primarily that he offers really dangerous advice to vulnerable people. And that has a very real impact on individuals, on the families in which the individuals are involved. And ultimately, that's as far as it goes. If he practiced within a reasonable ethical framework and responsibly, complementary to medical practice, I'd say go crazy, charge as much as you want for your bullshit. But the minute you step into stop taking your meds, don't seek treatment, or as he put it, go into the woods and live on herbs and drink urine. And that's a quote.
Yeah, he really said that.
Then that's a problem for me, because this hurts real people here on this plane and has the potential to continue doing so for as long as he's making these absurd videos. And that's why I'm going to make fun of him and continue to make fun of him when he's doing damage.
He's never going to stop. You know, it would be one thing if he... Hold on a second. I got to play the clip. Start playing too early.
You fucking ruin everything.
Shut up.
Ha ha.
If Patrick were to put, like, this is for entertainment purposes only in his views or videos, it would be one thing. But, you know, even if he did that, he would still go around it and act like it's not. Not that he would ever do that, because he feels like it would discredit the power he has over people. But I have less of a problem when there's somebody claiming to have these powers who straight up says, like, yeah, I'm an entertainer. That's obviously not anywhere near as problematic as somebody who literally is telling people, God damn it, screen share. He's literally telling people not to take their fucking medication, so.
I mean, I've literally seen, like, in the newspapers that, like, you know, a psychic will have their number in there or some shit, and it'll say for entertainment purposes only.
Yeah.
That's one thing. You know, at least you know what you're getting into right then and there.
Yeah. By responsible practice, I mean, a responsible and accredited healer would notice and be very aware of and concerned about the obvious signs of psychosis, like hallucinations.
No, he encourages that. So
no, I was just playing a character then. It was just satire, guys.
He's smiling, like, so deviously when he says that it was all performance. He goes, this was performance art. Now what are you going to say? I got one over on you guys.
So stupid.
Like, you're so stupid. You're revealing that you're lying in the very fucking video.
I was only just pretending to be retarded.
Yeah. I was just pretending that I wanted to fuck a 14-year-old boy, because that's something that sane people do. Does the writer's muse have any explanation for this?
So, Barack Obama, fuck you! Fuck you for running in this country. Look at this gorgeous painted man. Fuck you, Barack Obama! You are the worst president ever, and you're a nigger. Fuck you, and you're a nigger. And you're a nigger. And you're a nigger.
What do you have to say for yourself, Writer's Muse?
Hey, what do you think of that, Amy? Is that for our spiritual development that he says that? Fucking moron. I swear you look so goddamn stupid when you defend this piece of garbage. Do you feel no shame at how you're perceived for defending someone who is so obviously a disgusting piece of trash? Jesus Christ, what's wrong with you?
And she's obviously just doing this for her own entertainment, it seems. I honestly think she knows deep down that he is a piece of shit, but she's just into that because of the twirling nails.
Well, she likes it. She
likes being a fangirl for these fucking crazy type of dudes.
I'm going to give my psychic reading on her, okay? Somebody has twisted and manipulated her mind in the way that Patrick does it to these gay boys. I don't want to say what happened, but she has suffered some kind of abuse of a psychological nature, perhaps of more. But she's justified it, and she sided with not only her abuser, but every abuser who uses the same fucking logic as they got, you know, I'm not saying what happened. I'm just giving a psychic reading on what I feel happened. Am I right, Amy? Because I have a feeling that I am right. Guys, that was very condescending. If you leave a silence after I'm done, then I look like an asshole. Come on. Pick up the ball.
Honestly, I have I've spent as much time as I'm willing to communicating with the writer's muse for reasons that I've been clear on in the text.
She'll never go away while we're fighting the forces of shamanism.
Well, I mean, if she's going to dodge discussion, then she really just needs to fuck off then. That's my view of it.
My attitude to that is, you don't agree with me, that's fine. So back up your position, or, you know, invoke magical powers, and then the conversation's over. It's the equivalent rhetorically of saying, I believe in God and magic, and fairies did it, unless you can back up your position. So I'm really done with it. But make a video, respond to mine, we can have a conversation. But if you're just going to preach your position and invoke magic, there is no conversation to be had. And I hope you enjoy supporting Patrick, because he has a habit, almost an uninterrupted habit, of exploiting the people who offer him assistance.
I mean, to be honest, what we even say about him could be of assistance to you, because he's going to eventually fuck you over just like he does everybody else.
I bet she's given him money, dude.
I bet she has.
She's given him money.
I wouldn't put it past her one bit.
In fact, I guarantee that she has given him money at least once, if not many more times than that. She may very well be someone that he relies on to survive. And I bet you also that he is one of her only friends that talks to her. So she has a huge investment in defending this fucking guy, because he's probably one of the only people that pays her any attention.
Oh, yeah. He's the one person that'll listen to her insane bullshit. Like, watching her videos is so fucking tedious. Like, she just rambles about crazy shit.
Somebody told me she seems like the type of lady who would, like, start writing letters to death row inmates and end up marrying them.
Oh, yeah.
I totally fucking believe that shit.
Oh, yeah. She's totally, like, a groupie type, like, of those prisoners that you'd see. Like, they end up falling in love writing them and shit and want to go and marry them. Go have conjugal visits with fucking Charles Manson, you know?
Well, the best she's got to throw at us is that I'm a drunk and that we're all dirty, evil vampires. And the best we have to throw at her is that she's a Charles Manson supporter who is defending a domestic abuse, domestic abusers. So, sorry, that's my drunkenness, because I'm a dirty, evil, drunk vampire.
Can I jump in very, very briefly right
now? No!
There? I just want to throw a quick thing as a kind of thought experiment here. Do you think these ladies would leap to Patrick's defense if there was a gender difference here? For instance, if he was a 44-year-old man beating the shit out of a 22-year-old girl.
It would be totally different. It's kind of...
I think it would be totally different, and I wonder why that is.
Well, she probably just doesn't view gay people to have the same value in their life as a straight person, but what do I know? I mean, that's just total speculation.
I don't know if it would be different, but I kind of think it would.
Well, I know if it were a woman, this bitch would not be defending her. She'd be attacking the shit out of her, trying to take her place, so.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, that's a perfect segue into our first video, guys. It's Amy Shaw, that's her name. She has a blog that has literally zero comments on every single post. Let me get this loaded up here.
And aren't comments disabled on her videos, too?
Not all of them, but the one about us, yes.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's probably just as well.
Yeah, she even somebody...
Go ahead. I was just going to say, she made a statement in the video even saying, before you guys make a comment, blah, blah, blah. And as soon as she said that, I'd go to scroll down just to see what people would say. And there was nothing there.
Nobody cares about her fucking bullshit. Even Patrick doesn't care about it. He puts up with it because there's some benefit to their relationship. And if you can't see that, Amy, it's probably good for you to listen to us when we tell you this, because you are being fucking used by this guy. He's a perpetual user who cannot help but use people. It's what he does. You can't tell a fucking bat not to suck blood. That's what they do. Vampire bat.
Mm.
Right. We want to skip a little bit past the beginning here. Well, who knows? What do we got? 17 minutes that we need to skip past where she talks about something.
Yeah, I think she brings this up like maybe 2 minutes in and then stops and then I think comes back to it later on. But she just talks incessantly about all kind of crazy shit.
Well, it's a driving video. The video she had to take while she was driving, which means that she's totally sane.
Yeah.
Yeah, psychic vampires do not encourage video making while driving.
I did that one.
Or operating heavy machinery, not a good idea.
No. I think there's a conspiracy afoot where, like, all these people that vlog and drive at the same time and they happen to just be crazy, there's something going on that's deeper.
I just want to see them wreck into each other. Two people making two conspiratard videos at the same time, not paying attention, both just head-on collision. That's what I want to see. And in this universe of infinite possibilities, it's bound to happen, right?
Possibly. Possibly. You have to attract it, though, with your thoughts.
What if she just, without another car, what if she just hit Patrick John Coleman as he drunkenly stumbles through the street? She was going to Chicago, right?
She's, like, doing one of these vlogs and finds him crying up against a tree and accidentally smacks into him.
Yeah, and then he asks her for money when she gets out of the car to see if he's okay. You make this go away. Go away.
Only I need $100. A rip it.
You know, I'm imagining a remake of Magnolia, but with characters like Patrick and Ryder Hughes.
There's so much.
Stories intersect. You know? Dude. It writes itself, really.
Anything with Patrick. I've had this idea for the Death of a Shaman screenplay for a while. I mean, Patrick, like, writes all of it for you. He's so unfucking believable. You could never make up a character as twisted and retarded as Patrick Coleman. So why don't you just, like, fucking copy him and put him in your story? Come on, everyone.
And I have a question for you guys. Because I got a lot of good feedback and a lot of negative feedback about the Robot Shaman laughter video. Uh-huh. You know, I want to tell you what is going on. I'm a robot from the future. That is funny, right?
I wasn't hilarious. Yeah. He's the gay Terminator.
I mean,
I'm a robot from the future. Come on, I have to make fun of that.
The future's like, we need to send back a person who will be very frightening in his demeanor and who will intimidate his enemies. Let's create a purple-haired faggot.
Yeah, what kind of stupid-ass motherfucker designed that robot? I mean, holy shit, what were they smoking?
You know, in the Terminator movie, Arnold Schwarzenegger's the perfect specimen. But here in the real world, it's Patrick John Coleman.
I'm here to terminate the juice in your ball.
The future was like, yeah, we want to fix the past, but, like, we don't really want to work that hard for it. Let's just send Patrick.
This weird motherfucker that thinks he's, like, possessed by Madonna and Prince and Harley Quinn, a cartoon character.
People in the future are so nihilistic that they decided to destroy the time-space continuum by trolling the past with Patrick John Coleman.
Yeah, I think it's actually part of a reality show from the future. He is, in fact, there.
Oh, my God. It really is a reality show.
Yeah. So we're on the Matrix, and, you know, Patrick's on the beach with his cape, with eye makeup smeared all over his face, shouting at the seagulls.
And the police are chasing him with nightsticks.
Yeah. He passes him by, and he's going, why are you scared of me? Why are you scared of me? Talking to the gulls.
Watch the sunrise with me.
Yeah, what was that crazy-ass whale cry that he did?
I don't know. I'm going to download that.
Sounds like a dog that got its balls snipped off. Mexican style. Snile. Style.
Snile.
Whatever.
What the fuck's
wrong with you? I'm not without empathy for other creatures in pain. But you know what? If you don't want to be made fun of, don't post your breakdowns all over YouTube. And then,
are you trying to tell us you're an empath?
Oh, absolutely. It's part of my dark mage plethora.
So it's real. So there are actual empaths. Wow.
Yes, I am an empath and I'm a seer.
Chaotic neutral.
Yeah. I'm coming out as a dark mage tonight. That's I've been wrestling.
The world's not ready. The world's not ready, Doc. Oh, sorry.
I love that goddamn word right here.
So I only roll that out for very special occasions, and I've been somewhat provoked this week, so it just comes out at times like that. You know?
The world's not ready for you to reveal that about yourself. Oh, cool, a car alarm's going off in the distance. I bet you'll all be able to hear it for the duration of the show. Awesome. Thanks, Patrick.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. 11 seconds, then we'll play Amy.
It is so painful. It is so painful.
Fucking weird.
Look at the sunrise with me. Look at the sunrise.
Imagine you get up in the morning, you open your window, look out, and you see this fucker in your courtyard just rummaging through the garbage.
He poops in the sand to everyone at the beach because his toilet doesn't flush because his water was shut off.
He buries it like a cat.
That was the day after the Patrick Butterfield. It was like 12 hours after the Patrick Butterfield interview, everyone. He was really affected.
Look at the sunrise.
But, you know, the tragic reality, guys, is when he posted his video, you know, and he's posting it in a public space and we're commenting about it. When he posted his video with the 24-ounce... 24-ounce Bloody Mary.
Bloody Mary.
Immediately it was like, oh, shaman forecast. We know how this works.
We were right. We were totally right.
Again and again and again. So he's interesting, but he's not complex in this regard.
It's just hilarious. I can see people... Patrick Butterfield said, yeah, people would watch it like it's a reality show. I'm like, I totally get that impression, except typically on reality shows, people don't end up dead on the show. It's usually after the show's over that they end up dead.
Yeah, maybe a couple years down the line after the cocaine's gotten to their heart a few too many times.
I mean, I've been criticized for making fun of this guy, and I've tried to get across that making fun of him is the only way I can absolutely stomach paying attention to him, and I pay attention to him because he's dangerous, both probably to himself and to others. So get some help and behave yourself, Patrick.
I have to take a pish.
I mean, in my opinion, if nobody had been paying attention to him all this time, then he would be like probably doing some way worse shit right now than what he is.
Yeah, I don't know that to be.
I mean, that's just nobody, you know, nobody can know for sure, but.
My attitude is if I'm making him uncomfortable because I'm paying attention to him, and many people are, you shouldn't put his stuff in a public environment. You know, make your videos, share them with your friends. If you don't like a critique, then you're in the wrong space. And incidentally, the only comments that I delete from my channel are the ones that have crimes in them in terms of threats. And I don't block anybody, so you're welcome. Come comment and, you know, have a conversation.
Hey, Doc, didn't he also just recently post up his pricing list again without, like, saying a word?
Well, actually, the price list has never been removed.
Yep, he's been doing it the whole time.
Oh, right. Okay. I thought I read something like that this morning. When we
No were... shame on this piece of garbage.
Yeah. 5 or 6 weeks ago, I forget which, Patrick announced that he would now be operating without charge, but his price list.
Oh, it's been like 3 months now. Actually,
he's never stopped.
That was let's say July, because wait, Vitaly's body was found May 29th. Patrick disappeared for like 2 weeks. So since June, it's now October. So that was like 4 months ago, actually.
So, to the best of my understanding, the price list has been up the whole time. And I know that Patrick was reminded about it on at least four occasions. So that is what it is. But as was indicated in Patrick Butterfield's comments, he's not really getting a lot of trade.
No, not at all. And you know what? Just to tell you guys, Patrick, this is a person who will say something that he literally has absolutely no intention of ever doing. He will just tell you he's going to do something to gain your favor, knowing the whole time that he's never going to fucking do it. He never took those prices down one time. So that's another indicator that this person's disgusting. But we need to watch some videos. Let's watch Amy. You guys ready?
Yeah, she looks fun.
This is Amy making a crazy video while she's driving, which is always a good idea.
They're usually the most sanest people and give the most soundest, you know, arguments. And
have the largest audiences.
And she's a seer, guys, so that means she's special.
For him, but all of that, here's my mood. The reason I'm recording this is because I have a dear beloved friend, someone that I've come to know very well, and I love very, very much. An amazing human being. Eccentric and, you know, what other kind of word could I use? There's a lot of different words I can use.
Eccentric dangerous. Works.
Dangerous. The word dangerous, maybe?
No, she would never use that word. Because he's actually developing people spiritually by abusing them.
Harmful?
No.
Insane maniac?
Yeah. I would never use the word beautiful, so hopefully she doesn't use that word.
Bloviating butthole?
Is he good at bloviating, though? I don't think he's good at it.
I just wanted to say bloviating because it's a fun word to say.
Rush Limbaugh's good at bloviating. Patrick just literally repeats himself. Literally.
When I make fun of him, I'm always drawn towards something like lurking freak show to get the richness of his character.
Yeah, it really sums him up. But here we go.
I just have a lot of love for him. Okay, so the thing on my mind today, he's getting cyberbullied really, really bad. And this has been going on for months, okay? Months. And today is okay, you hear me?
In case you guys...
Can I jump in?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, cyberbullying. I've tried to make a distinction in text between their understanding of cyberbullying and just the phenomenon that happens when you talk bullshit and a group of people independently go, this guy's a dick.
Yeah, we never told anybody to just, hey guys, run over here and just fuck with him out of the blue.
Dude, yeah. When you go in public, stand on a soapbox and make controversial statements, don't be shocked when people come along to tell you that they strongly disagree with everything you have to fucking say. That's how it fucking works. This is a public fucking forum.
And if you're a fucking idiot, don't be surprised if there's a crowd of people that form and they all stand around and call you so.
This guy is on record as punching his boyfriend in the face, slapping him. Oh, so many fucking horrible things. That's just Patrick Butterfield. We heard from Vino. I heard from Vitaly. All of this shit this son of a bitch does is on public record. So he thinks that this shit's going to come out and no one's going to say a fucking word to him about it? I mean, that's not how it works, dumbass.
Yeah.
When you put yourself on the line, you better be prepared to risk what's going to happen.
And I thought that flaunting the new partner, and I won't mention his name, was a particularly Coleman-esque thing to do.
Oh, yeah. We're not going to say his name, but Patrick's fiance, and this is not the first time he's had a fiance, nor shall it be the last, although hopefully it is the last. This person is somebody who has excelled in life, who comes from a decent background, and who has shit going on. He can have a fucking bright future. And Patrick says, not if I have anything to say about it. Swoops in like the goddamn parasite that he is to fuck everything up. I'm trying to be a little vague here, everyone.
Let's not go any further into that.
Yeah.
But yeah, guys, if you've interacted with the writer's muse, now you can put a face to all those hateful, retarded comments you've read. Okay? This is who is leaving those comments. This is the writer's muse, everyone. Now you see her.
For me, I'm coming, Patrick. I'm coming, and it's going to stop, baby. It's no more. It's done. Okay?
This video was about a week ago, and yet here we are now, so I guess her powers of persuasion were a little exaggerated.
Months this has been going on, and, you know, I was up late last night counseling him, you know, doing it. I was counseling him and doing some, you know, work, and, you know, they're relentless. They're relentless, and, you know,
Can I chime in, Michael?
Yes.
Months it's been going on. Actually, it's been going on exactly as long as Vitaly's been confirmed dead.
Yeah, and well, I mean, me and Ron were going after him before that, but since then, it's like, it's not even a fucking joke anymore. Now it's serious.
If you're talking about Shaman Watch, Amy, the night that Vitaly died, I started paying attention to Patrick. And fortunately, I was able to acquire a number of his videos, like 50 of them, that he deleted.
Yeah, she forgets. She forgets. Sorry.
That he deleted immediately after Vitaly's death.
Exactly. You can say whatever you want, but he deleted the evidence. You can't argue with the fact that he deleted all of those videos where he channels Vitaly, where he merges with his soul, where he threatens Vitaly's family, the video where he threatens to kill Vitaly. You can't deny that these things exist, so you just ignore them. You pretend that they don't exist. But they fucking do. We've seen this guy. So don't fucking act like he's somebody who is not the person who revealed himself to us. He willingly showed us that shit, Amy. We didn't sneak into his apartment and secretly film him. That's the crap he chose to show us and then changed his mind about later. But this is the internet. This shit's going to be around forever now.
Yeah, I mean, nobody ever put a gun to his head and told him to start doing this shit.
He called you and told you the most incriminating shit of his own free will.
I did not call him that day. He fucking called me out of the blue and just told me all kinds of fucking crazy shit. This was when Vitaly was still alive. It's still up on my channel.
There's even a one where he encourages Vitaly to lie about his black eye. Like, we fucking blew up the audio. We catch him lying. So many times we've caught him lying. And you still fucking defend him and say everyone else is lying. You're a fucking idiot, Amy.
I mean, there was like a domestic thing and all kind of shit that was between them. That he fucking hit that guy.
Yeah. And in case there's any issue about my concerns about medical claims, there's a whole series of Dr. Shaman videos. And there are at least 7, if not more, where he is talking, stay away from psychiatry. Psychiatrists are evil. They're all corrupt. Here's some bogus information for you. Stop taking your meds. That stuff isn't going anywhere.
Well, it's never going to go anywhere because unless Patrick gets locked up, then we have every reason to continue telling people what he's doing, which is preying on weak people. That's just what he fucking does.
Yeah. And if you don't like it, please respond. Please come on the show and talk about it.
Debate us, Amy. Come on. You know what? If Amy came on here, I know we're all a bunch of assholes, but I swear to God, the second that this lady came on here, all of us would just give her a fair fucking chance. I mean, we gave Brett Bernhoff the fair chance after he repeatedly slandered me and, you know, said all kinds of shit about this show and all of us. We still were nice to him until he repeated the slander over and over again without providing a shred of evidence. So, Amy, if you really, truly believe what you're saying, just come on here.
Yeah. And even if your reason for believing is because you want the best for Patrick, that's fine. You know, if it's a spiritual reason, if whatever is necessary. But as things stand, there is no argument coming from you. I'm hearing emotion and I'm hearing opinion. Depends on everyone else being completely incorrect.
Hey, Amy, let me ask you a question. After your interactions with Patrick, do you feel drained? Do you feel like you weren't allowed to speak about your own problems even one time and that it was all about Patrick? Do you feel like maybe you're Patrick's blood bag and that he's sucking the fucking life out of you? Because that's what you are, Amy. You're
nothing but
Patrick's blood bag, okay? You're his supply.
And a fucking ATM.
Yeah, speaking of his, he likes to talk about narcissistic supply. What do you think you are, Amy? You're a fucking victim of Patrick, okay? So stop defending this guy because you have extreme Stockholm syndrome. You're nothing but, as Ron said, I'm sure you're a fucking ATM for this guy.
She's and a fish sure, on a hook, dude.
Yeah, and he's a little attention whore, and you're giving him all the attention. You're letting hook, him suck you dry, and you like it. Admit it.
Hook, line, and fucking sinker. I mean, you are completely falling for it.
And with that, I'm done speaking with this person.
Well, we have way more Amy videos to go. Unless you guys want to just say, screw Amy and move on to another retard.
Yeah, you can see another stupid shit she says. I don't care.
What do you think, Doc?
Yeah, let's hear Amy. Let's get, you know, in her absence, the best shake that we can to her story.
Yeah, let's, you know, it's better, after all we've said, it's better that people continue to watch Amy and see her for what she really is.
Game goal is here, and I'm just sick of it, okay? It's going to stop. And before you leave comments or say anything to me about, just block them, just these trolls, just block them, just ignore them, report them. Look, we've done all that and then some, and, you know.
I think Patrick's been flagging our videos. I mean, I didn't know that.
That's not happened. I've not been blocked, and I've not been flagged.
I'm not blocked either.
Yeah, me either.
I still have him on my Skype list. I could fucking show you right now.
Dude, Patrick blocked me and then unblocked me because he would rather people see my comments so he can play the victim.
You know what, guys? Yeah. I actually forgot to tell you. Just the other day, he sent me a private message on YouTube linking me to a Patrick Butterfield video.
Like, you son of a bitch. How could you not tell us that Patrick communicated with you?
It completely slid past my fucking memory because I had to go immediately into work, but
you're working with Patrick, aren't you?
He just sent me a link of like an old Butterfield video where he was like talking about how his parents are dicks, basically.
Who gives a shit?
Yeah. And I'm like, dude, that's Patrick no longer Vader. Relevant as of that conversation that we had with Butterfield. Your fucking videos are a joke.
Did Butterfield even say in his video, like, yeah, I love my mom, everything she's... No, he said he doesn't even have a good relationship with her. So who gives a shit if he said his parents were dicks? Does that change the fact that you punched him in his fucking face, you if piece any, of shit?
If anything, this proves that there's a pattern between your relationships where they all have a problem with their parents.
Yeah, that's how you see
it. And you take advantage of it. You want to be Uncle Patrick.
Yeah,
it's wants to be Mommy Patrick. That's who he wants to be.
That is mirrored also exactly in a video in which Vitaly appears that obviously I'm not going to publish, but it is available for anyone who wants to see it. And it's absolutely horrific. But I watched Patrick Butterfield's comments about how everything's fine and so on in a video with Patrick. And I noticed that Patrick Coleman is wandering about in the background, kind of lurking behind the video.
He's
and,
so transparent, dude.
Smoking up in the bathroom. I mean, the whole thing took on a much more sinister air in light of what Patrick said, and very eloquently and very sincerely, I thought.
People have been... Okay, Patrick has like three friends, okay? And they have decided to come out of the woodwork and start smearing Patrick Butterfield after he was courageous enough to tell us what really happened. One guy was, what's the, there's like a shaman collective. Jesus Christ, I can't remember their name. You just showed me their comment earlier, and I said it was really heinous.
Yeah, let's not publicize the name.
Yeah, we won't publicize the name, but these people are saying, like, you are just an opportunist who's lying. What opportunity does he have by telling us he was domestically abused? What fucking opportunity does that grant him, you idiots? I mean, why would somebody come out and tell you that that happened to them unless they felt it was important? No one's going to make that shit up and throw themselves under the bus like that.
What I found particularly compelling and convincing, because yeah, I've never spoken with Patrick before, but it was an honor to do so, was the level of detail in the description of one of the domestic abuse events, the round slap and the whole thing.
Yeah, and he poured the beer over his head. He slapped him, and then he poured a beer over his head to humiliate him.
Yeah, but guys, you also got to remember Patrick Butterfield's mom's paying us to say all this.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. Yeah. You know, wasn't Patrick supposed to be dead so 1 week? Wasn't Coleman supposed to die 1 week after we interviewed the Butterfield?
Yeah, that's right. He actually did make a video like that. It's up on Ian's channel, too.
Although, I hear he's telling Amy that if he dies, to report to the authorities what happened. So Patrick's now implying that we're literally trying to kill him. No, bitch! We're just trying to get you locked up where you belong!
Yeah, and we've gone on the record repeatedly as wishing him no physical harm, but we want him to not be a risk to others or himself. So that's it, and that's all. We'll never support violence against anybody because it's not what we do.
You know, I just love that Patrick's response, when we catch him talking to the 14-year-old boy, his response is, "Ha ha, I made it up." Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? You think that is the defense that you actually have the nerve to laugh over? I mean, what the fuck? You think you outsmarted us by making yourself look like a pedophile?
I was only just pretending to be a fucking dirty old pedophile that's going to be this 14-year-old kid's uncle.
He did not trick us either, because that 14-year-old video was before me or you, Ron, ever made a single fucking video about this guy.
Exactly, and he got so many supportive comments. The thing is like he got so many supportive comments on this shit, like back before anybody actually started paying attention to what a shitbag he is. And then when that was exposed, like whenever the fucking lights turned on and he's a roach scurrying under the fucking refrigerator now. Deleting videos and doing this and that. And
literally hiding evidence because he thinks the police are watching him. So he starts hiding the evidence. I mean, how could you look less guilty?
Then he starts like out of the blue saying we killed him, or Michael specifically
saying I killed him.
Yeah.
You, Patrick. You're the fucking person who's responsible for this shit.
And you just know he had like people like Auld Kindle in his ear just saying like, oh yeah, the Canadian border, blah, blah, blah. And it's just so fucking stupid, Patrick, that you go through.
I have to reintroduce Walter, the Ugandan DJ.
Oh, God. I hear he's a great DJ. And he makes songs about kill Omni Arrows.
Kill fucking Omni Arrows.
Kill Omni fucking Arrows.
So, yeah.
My landlord stole my Xbox. Mm.
Stop it. Stop it or we won't be able to stop. Stop it now. All right, continuing.
Old has floated the story that Vitaly, peace be upon him, has been cloned into the body of a Ugandan DJ called Walter. And he was able to say that with a straight face, which is more than I can do.
Was it really a straight face?
It looked like it was a smirk. To me, like
he smirks a lot because he's a lying piece of shit. So.
He's a greasy, smug, fat bitch. Is all he is. To be honest.
Certain people, I don't want to talk about. But Auld Kindle, we're not done with you. You fucking dirty piece of shit.
I buy a fucking long shot, buddy.
Demetria.
Yeah, very important meeting on the ninth dimension. Yeah. Bollocks. Bollocks.
Oh, Josh.
We met up with Agent Snow. Agent Snow was there, and Morgan Freeman, and we all sat around and drank astral tea, and then we saw like a little video play where we saw Omni Arrows, Michael, who slit Vitaly's throat, and then clone him and turn him into a Ugandan DJ.
You know what? Auld Kindle thinks he's a chess master. But I just want him to watch in the coming weeks what happens to all of his pawns and know that the same shit's going to happen to him. Okay, Auld? You fucking dirty piece of shit. All right? All right. How about more Amy? Do you guys want to do more Amy, or do you want to get some more retards?
Yeah, let's hear just a little bit more. Just a little bit more.
Okay, you're the boss, Ron.
That's right.
It isn't really even a matter of that. I mean, it's multiple avenues of social media and multiple daily. I mean, you know, Patrick uploaded a video yesterday, just two videos actually, where he's just clearly like, he's...
Are one of those videos the one where he accuses me of slitting his ex-boyfriend's throat, you fucking bitch? I mean, don't deny that he said that, you fucking moron. Do you really think that I did that? If you know, like any intelligent person, that I didn't, then how can you defend him making such comments? You're fucking dumb bitch. Art.
It's just performance art, and you just don't get his artistic brilliance.
I have performance art. Amy K. Shaw likes to eat feces, but that's all performance art. That whole joke is a performance art, everyone.
Like, he called you by your full name and said you killed someone.
Actually, everyone thinks my name's Michael Chen Thompson, but legally, that is not my name. I never changed my name to my husband. I never fucking did that shit. So, they think that they got one over on me because they know my real name. But if they were all actually smart, they would know that my very first video ever uploaded to YouTube actually had my real name in the title. So, what the... You're fucking stupid. All of you are stupid. I even said my real name on the last episode. I said my full fucking name. But they still think it's Chen Thompson because they don't pay attention.
Yeah. Accusing someone of a very serious crime isn't a cool thing to do if you've got zip to back it up. And if you do have anything to back it up, call the cop immediately.
Yeah. Why are you withholding evidence?
So,
hey guys, I think we may have a very special guest about to pop on. Oh my god, it's going to be crazy. How about we wrap CW, up our bucket up?
It's not.
I swear to god, it is not CW.
I'll slap the shit out of you, boy. You better
it's
not.
It's a real special guest. How about we wrap up our thoughts about Amy and then we'll get our special guest on?
Yeah, okay.
Doc, any final thoughts about the lovely lady named Amy K. Shaw?
Well, I'm done talking really because I laid out my position and I gave reasons for holding that position. But it's like talking to a creationist about science. Once you introduce magic, there is no discussion.
Well, that's true. She is... I mean, we can sit here and debate how retarded she is all day long, but, like, all we need to do is say, like, this lady loves Charles Manson. This lady loves Patrick Holman. Do we have to discredit her? No, because she does it to herself.
There's nothing really to say about her, to be honest. She's not worth the fucking time because she won't bother making a goddamn argument.
Okay, Carlos. I mean, CW, how's it going?
Man, I fucking told you.
Wow, you look very CW-esque tonight.
See, guys, CW I just wanted has the power to tell you, to pop up everywhere.
I just wanted to tell you, now my cat has suicidal ideation. The fact of the matter is,
I'm sorry we chained your cat.
Horse thieves. And Ron, you're trying to imitate? Are you trying to imitate? I'm lying, I'm dying, Ron.
I'm really sorry, man.
A $2 beard. Unbelievable.
Yeah, I told him you were going to come for him with a knife for stealing your fucking bit.
Oh, you see the negative energy. You see the negative energy.
That's a lot.
You need to love. I love everybody.
Hey, say Broseph.
But fuck you, Ron, for say making Broseph. That caused my cat to have suicidal ideation.
I love you, but fuck you, okay?
I love you too. Oh, yeah, I thought I was your dad. I thought we were.
Oh, yeah, I forgot all about that. You're supposed to be his dad. Yeah. Ron, that's your dad. I forgot.
What happened with that? You know how easy it is that people forget.
How easy was it for you to forget me and mom when you went off to fucking Vegas to fucking blow everything on hookers, you piece of shit?
Wait a second. Look, let me tell you.
And then you just like ended up, you know, in that cat circus thing. That didn't work out so well. So you just start raping them, huh? And doing YouTube videos. See,
this is what caused L. Ron Kitty to have suicidal ideations. Indubitably, Ron.
You know what? You also made Mom have suicidal ideations.
Are we responsible?
Normative cat behavior.
Are we responsible if L. Ron Kitty kills himself?
Yes, it is true. You see, I know these things because I'm a lawyer.
Are you going to do a personal injury lawsuit for the cat?
I'm going to sue everybody, but I still love him.
So how's the ambulance chasing going, CW Ranter?
You know, people need to have protection. People have injuries, and they need to, you know, this is what happens. This is normative behavior now, you know, and I'm trying to express it. I'm seeking out my manifest destiny here.
And then
we get this from you horse thieves. Horse thieves. It's a clan of poison.
Do you just like sit in your car drinking beer and stuff outside of the emergency room, just waiting for fucking cars to pull up?
Well, it's not exactly my car. It's my secretary. My
How's your? I hear your mother. I mean, I'm sorry. Your secretary is not happy with her job. Are you going to give her a raise?
Well, it beats, you know, what I was doing. She was doing my lawn care before that, and I give her a promotion. Yeah.
Does she still wash your underwear?
I was going to say that. God damn.
Back in 2005, I stopped wearing underwear. I just have a really lot of body hair.
You know, there's something about CW, I will believe that to be true.
No, CW, I could see him wearing panties, but I'm not sure about underwear. So
you don't want me to have suicidal ideation with that kind of talk.
No, we don't.
If I'm lying, I'm dying.
You're the one that sounds suicidal because you're always talking about lying and dying.
Hey, say Broseph. Can you say Broseph?
Broseph.
Yeah. I'm coming for you, Broseph.
You know, you're starting to sound a lot like Jay Essex. Did I ever tell you about Jay Essex?
Yeah, you know, you've done about him.
I've done so many 3 or 4 hour boring, long driveling podcasts about Jay Essex, an old man that no one gives a shit about, but I'm dedicating a huge part of my worthless life to.
Jay Essex is a threat to society. What do you mean? It's very important that we make fun of Jay Essex.
Yes, I don't have a problem with this Patrick person that you're talking about. You know, he seems like a nice guy. But Jay Essex is the devil. He's Satan.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Jay Essex is way worse than Patrick.
Yeah.
How do you feel about Alt Kendall?
Alt Kendall, he's a nice man. I don't see the problem. We came on just to talk about spiritual shit. And things like that. You know? And I like his accent. He talks nice, you know, kind of like
a good accent. Boy, that was a shitty old Kendall accent. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm really sorry about it.
You know, the heavy water. The heavy water. I like that. Yeah, people. Yo, I'm looking at the chat. Yo, horse thieves. Yo, horse thieves.
CW. ACW. Is outer space a hologram?
It could be. I don't know. I'm not sure. I have a lot of opinions about it, but I don't know.
Do you have a particular opinion that you favor the most?
I think that life is like a normative sort of well of chanting. You know what I'm saying?
That's I agree. It's quite indubitable.
Indubitably, yes. And the fact of the matter is,
I said, fuck you, CW.
Fuck you, Dad.
Well, fuck you too. You know, but I love you. I love you. Happened to you? You're so quiet over there, but you're like an evil spirit.
He's rebooting because his programming went wrong.
That's the curse. That's the curse that I put on.
Curse.
I put the curse on you. I'll be
right back. You're not wiggling your hands nearly enough.
I would like that, but I got a cramp because I use this.
Want to be wild.
be. I love that song because I'm wild myself. Did I ever tell you I used to be a punk rocker?
Horses.
I used to be a punk rocker, and if I'm lying, I'm dying.
Yeah, your secretary, she was really mad at you a lot during those days.
Yes, she was, and I got a lot of spankings from her, and it wasn't good, you know. But you know what? It molded me into the person today that I am today, the great CW ranter. Because, you know, Ron, it is all about me. It really is. I just wanted you to let me know. Did I let you know? Did I ever tell you that I'm a lawyer?
No, I forgot that. Yeah,
maybe I've never mentioned that before. And, you know, the fact of the matter is it's the normative, indubitably well of Commonwealth of, you know.
You just really completely lost me with that fucking sentence.
Did I mention I used to be a punk rocker? Did I? I don't know if I ever did. I'm not sure.
CW Rancer.
I don't know. I don't know if I did or not.
I used to be a punk rocker, guys.
You're making fun, Ron, and we used to be friends. I used to be the dad. Remember when I was the dad?
He's the dad now.
So he gave mom suicidal ideations.
Leonard's daddy.
You know, I feel bad about that. I really do. You know, and I'm sorry to everybody if I hurt anybody's feelings. And I try not to say anything to hurt anyone's feelings. But fuck all of you!
Hey, Mr. Rancer. Can you please describe...
Yes, you evil bastard that I love.
What is the purpose of Commonwealth chanting?
What it has to do with the spiritual aspect of the universe, which is holographic, and the fact of the matter is, indubitably, what it does is takes the sphere of the spiritual aspects, and it transcends those into... by the way, did I ever tell you I was a lawyer? I'm not sure if I mentioned that or not.
What kind of lawyer?
Well, I don't like to say here because you're a very important man. I really am, you know. And if I'm lying, I'm dying.
Mr. Ranter, you are a better guest than Josh, Lord of the Winds.
You know, don't pick on the Joshes and the... And the Patrick Colemans, because you know they could have suicidal ideation, there could be a manifest destiny that affects our commas.
I don't want Patrick's wart to kill itself, so we got to stop making fun of it.
Yeah, you know he's just a sad man. Maybe he's a nice guy. I don't know, but you know we need to focus on the bigger pictures.
No, you're right.
The bigger picture.
How can we attack Patrick John Coleman when Hitler existed? Why aren't we bitching about Hitler?
Well, maybe Hitler existed in a different timeline.
Oh, you're right.
You know? And we don't know. I wasn't with Hitler. I'm just saying that, you know what? I never touched that cat. I never touched that cat. You fucking assholes that said that to me.
You're not going to Mandela effect this away, Dad. I promise you.
Well, you know, Ron, we used to be friends, and I'm not sure. Even Addison, with Addison, we used to talk about gaming, where I would, you know, stay up at night, you know, playing games because I didn't have any friends because I was kind of an asshole to everybody. But, you know, did I mention I was a lawyer?
No.
I'm not sure if I did.
How do you feel about Richard Ramirez?
Richard Ramirez, you know, you need to be careful how you say that name. That's a Latino name, and you sound racist.
You know? You don't want to give Richard Ramirez suicidal ideation.
No, it's a terrible. You know, can you imagine the karma that you would get from that? It's terrible.
How do you feel about cat murder? How do you feel about murdering cats?
Well, I feel the same way I feel about murdering cats as I feel about Jay Essex. Did I ever talk about Jay Essex? That fucker's evil.
He's a real threat to society.
He is. I don't know why we're even focusing on you know, Patrick John Coleman. And he has beautiful hair now, doesn't he?
What? I feel really ashamed now. Mr. Ranters brought it up. We spent two episodes, and we devoted like an hour and a half to Jay Essex. What the fuck is wrong with us, guys?
I'm telling you, you need to focus more on Jay Essex. Jay Essex
That shit was so boring, man.
It's so cringy.
He might be a reptile. I'm not sure. But I do want to say
I'm a self-proclaimed expert on J-Ethics.
I
know exactly how many overalls he has.
Is that supposed to be some kind of imitation?
No.
I find that insulting. And by the way, I want to say
on the ground. I better pick it up.
Just for the record, fuck you, Carlos Sharp, you bastard.
Yeah, and fuck K too. Remember, throw that.
Oh, terrible people! They're terrible.
They're so horrible.
They're horse thieves.
You scared horse them thieves. Off.
Yeah, go fuck your mother, Carlos.
Yeah, Carlos. What kind of name is that? He always wears some kind of a mask. What are you, ashamed of yourself?
Yeah, are you hiding? You're not really in Iceland, are you, Carlos?
No, he says he's in Central Mexico. I don't think so. With a name like Carlos, that doesn't sound like a Latino name to me.
It doesn't.
It sounds Irish, right?
Who knows? I don't know. He's the devil. He's evil. He's a horse thief.
Not really.
He's
a hologram.
He's a horse thief. And I don't think that's his wife.
His handler.
He's too ugly. That's why he wears that mask. Yep. You know?
Carlos is like Dark Man. Once you take off the mask, his face is just gone.
I think
bullet hit it.
You know when you go to the zoo and you see the baboons and they got those really red butts? I think that's probably what Carlos's face looks.
Hey, CW Rancer, do those red baboon asses turn you on?
If I could get them to go meow, meow, they might.
Do you like it when they throw their feces at you?
I do that a little bit myself, but don't tell my mom's not monkeys? Here. My secretary's not here right now, so she doesn't know I throw the feces.
So CW Ranter goes to the zoo and throws his feces at the at the monkeys.
Well, you know, it's an eye for an eye, a turd for a turd. That's what I believe.
There you go.
You know?
CW Ranter, I'm so glad we have your expertise on. How about, do you want to watch a video with us and reveal your expertise?
Absolutely. I'm always willing. You know, because anything for attention here. Anything. Well, let me stick my face into the camera, because that's what I do. I have to hold your face like this. So
yeah, your cat, see. Too.
Yeah, my cat is in therapy right now, in psychic therapy, because of his suicidal ideations, because that fucker Ron in his song. Fuck
can you
run?
Hey, I know you have a picture of your cat's vagina on that PC. Can you at least show us that?
No, I can't, but I can make a symbol with my hand that I.
That's a wide vagina for a cat.
It's a very large cat in the back.
It's a large cat. All right, well, I'm glad we have you here because we're going to show a light worker singing the light language.
Absolutely. Let's do it. And by the way, I want to make sure everyone knows this podcast is all about me. I'm CW Ranta.
I was going to be the fourth psychic vampire, but they never let
me on. But you horse thieves took it. You horse thieves.
Addison and Juan showed that picture of me getting my peewee sucked by a kitty cat, and that's never been a thing.
I love when CW goes like, I wasn't made to be the second string on Psychic Vampires. I'm like, bitch, did anyone offer you the job?
Bitch, please. You're the guy that comes on and we say fuck you.
You know, you are horse thieves. You're a clan of poison. Look at this on your podcast, on your chat here.
Yeah.
What's the matter with you people?
Everyone in the chat's a degenerate. I say right now, they're all degenerates.
Degenerates, that's right. But you know what? I love them. If I'm lying, I'm dying.
Especially you, Andrew Kincaid, you dirty degenerate.
I really gotta say, man, you nail every single fucking thing, like the chat thing and everything. That's fucking
dude,
hilarious.
Dude, you got indubitably. We all knew CW was retarded, but Carlos got indubitably.
You bring up Carlos again. I don't want to hear that name. That fucking
sorry,
he mocked me. He mocked me.
I didn't want to trigger you.
You know what? I love him. But you know what? I'm going to put a curse on him. There's a curse on you. You fucking Carlos.
Fuck you, Carlos.
Fuck you, Carlos. Did I mention that I'm CW Vanta? Come to my channel and leave me some hits.
Ron, you're coughing like Patrick John Coleman right now.
I'm sorry.
You need to go to a doctor because that's not normal.
That's a curse.
I got a cold, dude. Baby. I'm sick. Dude, I just fuck off, you guys.
Floor. That is such a waste.
I love you, but fuck off.
All right, light language. Light language. All right, CW, pay close attention. We need your serious discernment on this lady.
Okay, Michael.
And good luck.
Don't call me Michael.
Happy spring. Happy full moon. Happy lunar eclipse. And I just had a burst of, I don't know, energy, I guess, that said to do a brief, just spontaneous springtime.
Here we go.
Galactic do language it, blessing. It, so here we are.
Happy crack smoking. Oh my God. Oh, my head's going to explode.
Light language. This is an alien language.
My head's going to fucking explode, man. I swear to God. Who the fuck does this? Look at me, I drank so much Starbucks, I'm so spiritual now. Let me sing like a retard and make up words as I go along and pretend I'm like Buddhist or something.
If I could just get her to go meow meow, it would be okay.
She will. She'll do it.
She's got them cat ears for you, CW.
You know what? She doesn't know any actual languages aside from English, but she knows hundreds of alien languages.
Horse thieves, making fun of a poor woman when she's just trying to express herself in a spiritual way.
Hey, CW, should we take her reality seriously?
Yes, I think you should. I think, because we create our own identity, I was talking to L. Ron Kitty the other day, and we discussed this, and I'm kind of losing my train of thought, so I just want to make sure everyone knows this is CW Ranta. And did I mention I'm a lawyer?
You and CW Kitty need to do a podcast every week. CW Kitty and CW Ranter could change the internet.
That would be great, but I'm going to be down by the hospital, by the emergency entrance down there. I got work to do down there.
I'm going to call the police immediately if you guys do that show. We're not going to have any kind of cat molestation going online.
Horse thieves.
I like smoking crack cocaine.
I want to just mention one more time, I'm CW Ranta, and it's sort of like...
what's your name again? What is
CW Ranta, I just want to make... Come over
and what is it you do again? I forgot, what is it you do for a living? What do you do for a living?
Well, I may not have mentioned this, but I'm a lawyer.
Oh, man.
Impressive, we're really impressed.
Yeah, I used to be a punk rocker and a Satanist and a Scientologist, but...
Really hard to keep my dick in my pants at how amazing you are, CW.
I got a boner, I want to put it in your face, even though you look like...
I want to rub it on your
Adams
beard.
Family.
I want to make your beard sticky like you just ate a honey sandwich.
And, after all of that colorful past, which is very impressive, you're starting a religion.
Yeah. I am. It's the normative cat behavior commonwealth of ranting.
Hey, is it normative cat behavior for cats to like to be fingered by human beings?
Especially deep throating your finger,
you brought that up, and that caused my cat to have suicidal ideation.
I'm sorry, Kitty. I'm sorry, Leonard.
That cat saved my life.
Hey,
is the cat still in counseling or?
Listen,
what happened was a mouse got in my beard. while I was sleeping. It was suffocating me. And that cat ran to my rescue and pulled that mouse out, and I was able to breathe again. It was like a miracle. It was a miracle.
Questy.
Is your cat's name Leonard Chanter?
No, it's Elron Kitty.
Is it Leonard the Botnik?
Yeah, I heard it was like Leonard Zebediah Zabot's Robotnik.
Yeah, Robotnik.
You know, Ron, we used to be friends. You used to call me Dad. And see what it's degraded to? Indubitably.
Ron, and it's not a human. The matter
is that you know, I put a curse. I did it out of love.
You know what? There's
and by the way, I'm CW Ranter.
Hey. Lisa, what did you mean by making that joke saying my dick was small? It's not. I promise.
Even if it's not small.
You know what, Ron? That like a baby's arm holding an apple. You know what I mean?
Oh, you know what?
Even if CW has a large penis, it's hairy and smelly and covered in cheese. Gross!
I heard he was born with two foreskins.
Nobody wants it anyway.
I use one of them as a hoodie.
It could be the most beautiful dick in the galaxy, but no one would ever admit to having sex with you because it's CW Chancer on the other end.
You see the abuse I take here? I bring love and good energy.
I know, my mustache
was built for riding.
It's like if you gave a rock party, you know, and you hire a DJ, and you get the tables and chairs, and you get a band, and you serve drinks, and then you come and you shit it all up. It's like that. I wanted to give that analogy, and if I'm lying, I'm dying.
I'm sorry. Guys, I know what will clear this negative energy up. Some light language singing.
What is wrong with white people these days?
They're bored and they have no adversity, so they sing light language.
Like she just gets home from dropping her kids off at school and then
I'm gonna make a video. I'm so high on this Starbucks right now.
Oh, say open my mouth, retard.
You know, you horse thieves.
Infection.
You horse thieves. You're like the kids. Thieves. You're like the kids in the neighborhood who keep calling me Cookie Monster. You're horse.
I'm sorry. I feel guilty about it. I'm sorry.
You know who's really the horse thief? Teal Swan.
Did you say teal? We all know what the color teal means.
She was probably a beautiful spirit. She just is troubled. I don't want to say anything about it because she might have suicidal ideations.
I think she has a connection with horses like you do with cats.
Guys, we don't want Teal Swan to kill herself because that's likely. That's totally likely.
When you do that, she could possibly have spontaneous combustion. She would go off in a big ball of flame and nothing would be left but a fireproof silicone breast. There would be nothing left except those.
Okay, I just had an image of Teal Swan spontaneously combusting, and her boobs are two silicone explosions when the fire reaches them.
And then that silicone would fly up and hurt cats.
And then the genie had
any cats.
Genies would come out of her boobs and grant us all three wishes.
She would shit a genie right out of her dick nipple.
Hey, guys. Never mind. I can't do a Robin Williams impression. I quit.
By the way, fuck you. Fuck you, Jay Essex.
I love you, but fuck you.
I do love that guy. I'm trying to help him. It's trying to bring good energy into his life. Into his bloated, miserable, pus-filled life.
Do you think that you have the soul of a cat, CW Ranter?
I do.
I think he's a cat dimension.
I'm like a cat man. I'm like a feline man. Like a feline sapien. That's why I have these beautiful flowing locks.
It makes sense. You're a lion.
CW, is it true that you you can manifest that will anywhere all over the world.
Yes, I can, except for Central Mexico, where that fucking color shop is.
Yeah.
That
bastard. He's got more power than you, CW.
I hate that guy, but I love him.
Well, you know what? I know what's going to increase the love. More light language singing.
More, please. I'm really enjoying it. I'm thinking of downloading it from iTunes.
Do it. It's seldom.
Oh, my God. I'm so drunk.
My third eye is going to explode. When's this bitch's mixtape coming out? I'm going to buy that shit.
Okay, first off, this video is called Spring and Fall into Harmony Galactic Shaman Energy Healing. Sass Payel, go put this to a techno remix. God damn it, go do it. Okay?
You know, I think this woman is farting rainbows.
She is, and her farts are coming out of her face.
Would you eat those rainbows?
I will say, this woman is
lightning.
Would
you chase the rainbow, CW?
I like her. Do you like her, CW?
I do. I think, you know, but in my situation, I'm really in that. I'm open. Any woman will do if she's got a pulse.
What about cats? Will any cat do, male or female?
She has to be wearing a cat mask, right, Dad?
Question, but you know what? Then I would have to put another curse on you. And if I'm lying, I'm dying.
You remember how you used to make Mom put on that cat outfit and she was crying?
Catwoman's your favorite Batman villain, right?
Yes, but I like him a little bit fatter than that.
Oh, Samanasi!
Daddy likes a fat pussy.
Oh, Samalekalamalama.
I lick him, I lick him. You know what? Someone needs to shoot. A
Muhammad Jihad.
Quickly get a tranquilizer dart. Put her down.
Oh my God! You know I want to like use her singing and like play like some fucking Islamic fucking propaganda over it.
I can absolutely take care of that. But I kind of like this lady. I don't think she's doing harm, or at least she's not trying to.
Only for my ears.
She is both fun and funny.
It's the entertaining kind of crazy, if you ask me.
We like you, lady, but your singing is hilarious. It's so funny. Yeah.
So that's the difference between people like this lady and the scumbags that we tend to focus on.
Yeah.
And you know what? We're not being horrible and cruel. We're just making fun of her because she's funny.
Yeah, well, CW, question.
Kind of laughing
I look like the Wolfman.
No, you do. CW, I have a question.
Okay.
Have you ever anally penetrated a cat?
Well, you know, only for medical reasons.
What? Did you have to rescue a set of keys out of there or something? What were you doing?
It was very windy. But you know, Ron, we used to be friends. You used to call me Dad.
The cat swallowed his quaaludes, and those are hard to find.
Horse thief, Ron!
CW, we love you, CW. You're the best.
I love you too. You fucking bastards. I love you too.
Will you
CW Randy.
Will you curse my prostate, CW?
I will curse your prostate. May your prostate turn into a small handbag carried by a retarded old woman.
And may that old woman dwindle.
You mean like Amy Shaw?
I hope it dwindles. I hope your prostate dwindles.
It's dwindling right now.
Falls out like a little tiny BB.
My normally giant nuts are shrinking up.
That's because you're a horse thief.
That's true. I am.
Horse thieves.
Horse thieves.
Oh, Carlos is... Carlos is...
Yeah.
What the fuck are
Carlos?
You
doing?
He put a curse on me. That's fucking Carlos.
He's having a CW seizure.
This is what happens. Bastard.
When CW gets really into himself, he just starts to seize up. It's just too much for him.
He was slapboxing ghosts just then.
Wait! I'm getting a call.
Okay. Is it your mom?
Hello. I'm on the air right now. I'm on the air. I'm
He's on a client. The,
you know, and that those horse thieves, those bastards, Mom, they're treating me badly. They said I did nasty things.
Give your mom a raise.
Your secretary, Mom.
Yeah, give her a raise, dude.
Oh, you drive carefully. All right.
Do you ever get mad and fire your mom sometimes?
Do you? Serious question.
Okay, I will. I will do that. I will sand off your corns on your feet. I will do that. Okay?
With your teeth. Yes.
And I will do your nitty.
Ew, what?
Yes.
You do it with his dick, which
yes.
is not
Yes, fine. And I polished your Ouija board. Okay. All right. Bye, Mom. Bye.
Did you tell your mom hi for us?
Yes, that was my secretary.
Are you going to give your mom a raise?
Well, she doesn't have to carry my barbells down from the attic now. So, you know, it's something good comes from it, you know. It's all karma, you know.
It's all karma. You guys signed a soul contract, right?
We did. We signed a soul contract. You know, because I, you know, in a past life, I was a lawyer.
I know, in your past life, you're a lawyer, too.
In Egypt. I was an Egyptian.
Oh, okay.
Yes. I defended Moses.
Oh, it didn't go. That's a losing argument.
It didn't go. God. It was a lot of frogs.
All right.
I had like grasshoppers all in my beard, and they were going, "You shyster, you fucked up. Now we gotta go. We go to the desert."
We're stealing this lady's 15 seconds of fame. It's not fair to her.
We're horse thieves.
We're thieving her horses, man. You've got to stop.
Goodbye, horses.
I'm thieving all of you. Stealing horses.
And L. Ron Hubbard, Heil Hubbard.
Smoke methamphetamine.
You see, there could be young people listening to this, and you know that you're a clan of poison to tell people to smoke meth. There could be suicidal ideation.
Hey, is that your secretary again?
Hello, Ma.
Better fire her.
Hey, tell her we say hi.
Your mom's ruining the show again.
Hey, tell her I'll offer
$20. Wait, listen, she's yelling at me. Why do I put you on speaker, Ma?
Hey, tell her I'll offer $20 a year to be my secretary. It's a huge raise.
I want a mom, too.
What?
20 minutes, she's going to be home. I got to get the... Mom, I'm here. I'm, it's my manifest destiny. Ma, these horse thieves. Oh, I'm a lawyer, Ma. You can't talk to me like that.
Tell Grandma I said hi, and I'll promise I'll call her soon.
Okay, Ma. Okay, I'm sorry, Ma. Yeah.
But you don't want her to kick her out.
I told her.
Yeah, you're fucking. You're a big badass. You're a big badass ball of playa.
Yeah,
you don't want her to kick you out of the basement, dude. Be nice to your mom.
Because I am.
Be nice to your mom, or you'll end up in a basement like someone whose name is JBG initials. Anyway. Yeah.
That was humiliating.
Take it in, everyone. It'll take you a second to figure it out. But then you'll laugh really hard.
I would laugh, but then I would spit up some of the pea soup that I had, and it's really hard to get out of my beard.
I know, and that's really expensive dinner for you.
You know, I really, since I've grown this beard, I'm not really worried a whole lot about hygiene.
When you say pea soup, is that part of your urine therapy? Is that part of the common well of urine chanting?
Well, see, Ron, you know, you and I, we used to be friends. You used to call me dad. You know? And if I'm lying, I'm dying.
Answer the damn question, Dad. You're why drinking pee. Oh,
Jangle, it is, Paul.
How I know you're drinking pee. Like this? The spiritual realm is like a, it's like a ball, you know? But then it's not. It's like maybe not a ball, but more like a sphere. And, you know, in indubitably what I find, and the fact of the matter is, this energy that floats, it's all around us. We're all connected. We're all connected by you know, the all the gases and body fluids that we give off. And it gathers us all together in this great and wonderful commonwealth of Rand.
CW, are you a figment of a retarded imagination?
You know, retarded people are probably really tired of hearing you say that because it makes them feel bad. I bet there's some suicidal ideation out there by the community.
I don't want any retarded
on behalf of the retarded community, I want to say I apologize for Mr. Omni Eros Eris, who knows what his name is this week, you know. But I just want to say that we retarded people are offended by that kind of language.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I don't want to offend you. I don't want you to threaten to kill me and start slandering me on the internet for a week. I'm so sorry.
But I'm not a violent person. What I believe in the energy. I love you, but I do have to put a curse on you.
I hate you, CW. I hope you die in an ambulance wreck. Fuck you,
where's Edison? We used to be friends.
Fuck you, CW.
About you know, video games and other useless.
He can't stand you. He thinks you're a piece of shit. Edison says, "Fuck CW."
Yeah, somebody said here. I figured it out. CW Chant is really Carlos the Jackal.
No, he's not.
Horse thieves.
CW, horse you full of bitches.
I can't believe Carlos the Jackal. That is what he is. He's a jackal. And that's an insult to jackals everywhere. And, it, you know, the fact of the matter is, I've always wondered about this, Carlos.
Fuck CW Ranter.
You'll see, he wears like a medical mask. He puts on like a, you know, like a mask on his face. It butthead.
He doesn't have a mouth. He's a zombie.
Butt. He's got a shiny red baboon butt face.
Yeah. What an asshole. Well, how about more?
You know what? Omni, you talk about assholes like that's something bad. For us assholes out there, we are offended by that. You know?
Sorry.
You know, I'm having suicidal ideations because
I'm sorry, don't kill yourselves, assholes.
On behalf
of out there, please don't kill yourselves.
On behalf of all the assholes out there, we are a people. We are one. We are mighty.
You gotta be careful, Mike. Like, if we say much more, he's gonna like try to swallow his beard and kill himself.
That's how you know what a mouse wrapped up in my beard, and that's how that cat, L. Ron Kitty, saved my life.
Hey,
and you make fun of that? That was a moment. We had a moment.
It was L. Ron Kitty to the rescue.
I'm so sorry to have offended you, assholes. Please don't hold it against me, please, assholes. Please, you stupid assholes. Please don't hate me for offending you.
You know, assholes, you know, no, every group has some protection except retards and assholes. Nobody's protecting them. We should have, like, special laws to protect
them.
There
like, really should be laws against
Patrick John Coleman
retards and assholes.
You know, and he represents two categories of retard and asshole. Can you imagine how he feels right there?
He's a retarded asshole.
And you know what we really need? Ones that protect cat molesters, right?
You know,
yeah.
When I see someone walking down the street doing drugs with bozo hair, my heart goes out to them. It looks like he boiled his hair in Skittles. You
know? It really does, actually.
Sorry, you know, Patrick.
Taste the rainbow.
The worst thing I've ever done to anyone.
What do you think about Skittle farts? CW.
Skittle farts are really, you know, I think they may be a miracle of the Lord. Because Skittle farts, it changes the whole spectrum. Indubitably how this works, and the fact of the matter is, you have to embrace the Skittle fart. You know, you have to look at it. And by the way, I don't think Jay Essex can appreciate a Skittle fart. You know? That fucking bastard. JSX, okay. You're a fucker, but I love you.
You know what?
Did I mention that I'm...
Hey! CW Ranter, as usual, you're making this all about yourself, but we have this beautiful lady who can sing in alien language, and you have to make it all about yourself. Why? Why?
I honestly can't hear much more of this bitch is saying. She's going to make my head explode.
It's because, you know, I probably haven't mentioned this, but I'm a lawyer. Oh,
okay. I completely forgot. Thank you.
You know,
for
I was a punk rocker. Yeah, I was a Satanist, and I was a Scientologist, and now I'm a lawyer. With a resume like that, who wouldn't believe me? Who wouldn't listen to this? With a resume like that, I ask you.
Sounds legit.
I think horse thieves probably wouldn't listen.
See, horse thieves. You're the horse thieves. What?
Horse thieves. I just swallowed a jagged Jolly Rancher edge. Oh my god, it was so horrible.
See L. Ron Kitty, she's not even here for this. She's remitted herself to her boudoir.
Go take care of her vagina and she'll come back.
I don't know what her problem is. It's, you know, it's like that. You know.
Well, how about more light language? Shut up, Ron, just deal with it, bitch. Oh,
I want to hear actually just... Mila hana ya shi hana hi suru nuha
Ina hayuwa kaya shatarian kaya shoma halianda. Yes, what else is on the menu? I feel like I'm ordering off a Japanese menu.
Listen, Greg said that he would buy this lady's CD. Greg, what's wrong with you?
You know, Greg, we used to be friends. Dream C, we used to be friends. And now look what it's... Because you've joined this clan of poison.
Poison clan.
Horse thieves!
Assalamualaikum! Mohammed Daka Jihad!
Get your son to join ISIS.
She sounds like Pee Wee Herman.
Mecca, hi.
I used to sing that back when I was a punk rocker.
Fun time. So, CW.
Yes.
Do you only fuck cats?
You know, Omni, we used to be friends. You know, I love you, and yet this is why I had to put a curse on you, because of this negative... This negative energy, this cat issue. It's played out because, you know why? Because I don't absorb the energy. You're like a suppressive, going Scientology language.
My name is Pastor John Coleman, and we are watching.
That's a total accident. I'm sorry, everyone. It's a production accident.
It's awesome.
Sorry,
it's not an accident, it's your karma. That's part of the curse. It's karma.
My soul contract with Patrick. Soul contract.
I have a soul contract with his beard. It has woven itself into my nose hairs. I don't know if I can get it off.
When is it going to be able to go away? Is it for your whole life?
The beard nose hairs?
Did your finger have a fucking throat contract with your cat?
You know, Ron, I'm a lawyer. I don't know if I mentioned that.
No, you didn't.
Where's Addison? Addison and I used to be friends. We used to talk about, gaming and other things like that. Because, you know, I know I don't look like a gamer. You know, I look like somebody who may be out, in the clubs, you know, because I have sort of this hipster look. You know,
being a lawyer.
You know, beards are in right now because I'm kind of a hipster. You know.
Yeah, you're moving and grooving at the disco with that beard.
Moving and grooving.
My mother says it looks good. She says it looks nice.
Of course,
I bet she does.
Her salary depends on it.
Well, she doesn't have to carry my weights down from the attic now because they're giving her a different job.
Well, everyone, it's time for a break. So how about we use some final thoughts? CW Rancer, any final thoughts on the brilliant, brilliant segment that we've just had?
Well, what I think is everyone should go to my channel because there's nothing here but horse thieves. Horse thieves. Yeah. So that's my final words.
All right. Ron.
Ron, I love you, but fuck you, Ron, for that song.
Fuck you, Ron. CW, you cat rapist.
How dare you?
What, are you going to side with a cat molester now? I see how it is.
Yeah, I like the molester.
Cat raping fuckers.
I love
it. Maybe you rape the cats too, I guess, huh?
I'm going to rape your cat. What do you think of that, bitch?
I don't have one, so there.
Well, get one so I can rape it.
No, get your own.
I have one already.
Poor cats.
Just kidding. I have two dogs.
Hashtag cat throats matter.
All throats matter, you
please. No, they do not all matter. Well, they do, but there's a small minority of throats that are overlooked, and they're known as cat throats, okay? And there's a big epidemic of people like Dad over here, CW, that like to stick their finger down their cat.
Ian, any final thoughts?
You horse thief. Any final thoughts, you horse thief?
I really live in Iceland, bitch.
Asshole.
No, you don't. You live in Canada.
He's from Quebec.
Quebec?
I don't even think he's from Iceland. I think he's more from Slushland, which is not
I
quite.
I think he's from Georgia.
Yeah, he's from Soviet Georgia. I think so.
No, he's from Atlanta.
He's good at hiding that southern accent.
Well, guys, we all have to go choke on dicks for about 12 minutes. Is that okay? Is that okay, everyone?
I have to go. I have to go and do energy work and do some studies on Jay Essex and curse that fucker Carlos Sharp until
fuck Carlos.
Yeah, until I go to my bunk bed and down here in the basement and go to bed.
Well, thanks for joining us, CW Ranter. As always, you made every episode that you've ever appeared on much better with your appearance. So thank you so much. Again, you have made this a golden episode with your appearance, CW.
I just wanted to bless everyone with my presence.
Did you accidentally dox yourself this time? Are you going to make us edit the video so that we don't dox you?
No, but I can't stand up because I don't have any pants on right now.
All right, well, Zebediah Shekelwitz. I'll let you go, Ben. I'll talk to you.
Bye, honey. Love ya.
All right, love you too.
Bye,
and
Dad.
I realized that my deep throat and cats joke just didn't go over as well as I thought it would go. Anybody have anything to say before we go to a break?
No, let's do it. I got to pee, man.
Deep throat and cats.
Deep throat and cats.
Or cats deep throating. Whichever you prefer.
Go to credits.
Yeah, yeah, you're waiting. You fucked it up now. I look like a weird pervert. Fuck
yeah,
you guys. Because
you want to fuck a cat, you weirdo. God.
I'm going to go do it. It only takes 5 minutes. All right.
You.
Shut up, Ron, you asshole. Bitch. Fuck with me. Hold on a second. Shut up, I didn't burp. Suck my dick. This isn't awkward at all. You can all go to hell.
Hello, my name is Pastor John Coleman, and we are watching the sunrise. I don't know if you can see the sun rising on the beach. I'm existing in two realities. I am existing in two realities. I can't do this. I can't have one foot in the spirit world and one foot in the other world. It is so painful.
Watch the sunrise with me. I can't exist this way. I can't do this. God, please help me. I can do this. I'm a strong motherfucker. Strong bad, strong sad. Strong bad, strong sad. The cheat. The thief. The cheat. On this planet, this beautiful fucking planet with the sun rising. Watch the sunrise with me. Erotic city come alive.
Wild, born to be wild. Hello. This is something special tonight. I'm C.W. Ranta, and this is L. Ron Kitty, and she's not in any danger whatsoever, right, Kitty? Right? What are you doing? What are you doing? I just want to come and talk to you tonight about something that's very, very important. I want to talk to you about my religion that I'm creating called Normative Cat Commonwealth Ranting. Now, some people have negative feelings about religion and about spirituality, and I think that's ridiculous, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why, because I am C.W. Ranta, and I'm starting my own religion, and if I'm lying, I'm dying. Okay, so anyway, here we go. And I just want to say, for those of you who said bad stuff about my cat, and I love my cat, I really do. This cat is a wonderful cat. She saved my life. And you talk nasty and use bad words. Well, fuck you, Ron. Ron, you piece of evil shit. You've fallen into the cult, into the clan of poison. And it made me, but I still love you, okay? And if I'm lying, I'm dying. And that's, I'm demonstrably telling you this today, indubitably, because I'm a lawyer, and I'm a spiritualist, and a former Satanist, and a former Scientologist. And I've done all this stupid shit my whole life and believed a bunch of bullshit. So you should believe in me.
You should believe in me. You know what I'm saying? Because if I'm lying, I'm dying. Now, I love you guys, but, you know, I just want to talk a little bit about, you know, it's the salt and the sugar. You know what I'm saying? What are you doing, Kitty? Why are you trying to get away? Anyway, I just, and I love you guys. I just want to let you know that it's not about people who talk other people into committing suicide, who do drugs, and who abuse other people. It's not about that. It's not about that, is it, L. Ron Kitty? It's not. It's about being nice. And by the way, I wanted to tell you a little bit about me. It's all about me because I'm C.W. Ranta. And if I'm lying, I'm dying, you know? And let me tell you an analogy. Say, for instance, that L. Ron Kitty and I, we're setting up a rock party here. And what we do is we got some tables and we hire a bartender and we get a DJ and then we go and we get some shoes and some groceries and we get maybe a nice little, maybe some candles and we make a nice thing, you know, we're putting some nice stuff together. And I know how to do this because I'm a lawyer. And if I'm lying, I'm dying, you know, if I'm lying, I'm dying. So anyway, this is normative cat behavior that you're seeing here. And I just want to say, fuck you, Jay Essex. You piece of shit. I love you, but, you know, this is, you know, you're evil. You're poison. You're kind of like that Omni guy. You know, I was trying to take their show over and cause a bunch of shit and cause some problems and to backstab. What are you doing, kid? Anyway, so I was backstabbing people and, you know, doing things like that and doing the regular. By the way, did I mention that I'm C.W. Ranta and I'm making these long, boring, like 3-4 hour shows talking about Jay Essex and bullshit about spirituality and trying to start a religion called the Pisswell of, what is it, Common Normative? What's the name of our religion, Kitty? I can't remember, but it's, you know, I used to do a lot of drinking. I don't anymore. I was a punk rocker, but now I'm a lawyer. Now I am a very dignified lawyer. I'm a lawyer. I'm a dignified lawyer. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, I just want to talk about this for a little bit because, you know, it really is about me. It's really about me. Me, Benjamin C.W. Ranta. I am, you know, and the fact of the matter is that, you know, the fact of the matter is, hey, Kitty, what are you doing? She's trying to get away because she can feel the bad energy coming from Ron and his song and Omni and his people, his horse thieves, the horse thieves. She's running off now. See, you got her so upset, she ran off. I just want to say, That I'm going to put a curse on you, Omni. I love you, but I'm going to put a curse. I hope your underwear gets really, really tight and pinches your bum. I hope that birds fly over and shit all over you. And I hope that, you know, I invoke the powers that I don't believe in. And if I'm lying, I'm dying because I'm a lawyer, okay? And I just want to say this is the salt. You had the sugar. And this is the salt, you know, because if you're giving a party and you don't have the DJ where he's supposed to be and you don't have the normative cat behavior and you don't say, fuck you, Jay Essex, then, you know, this is what happens, you know. So you want to ask me a question? Just ask. That's it, because I love you. This is the internet. This is the alt media. This is the alt media. You know, here in my mother's basement, I am finding my destiny. I'm finding my destiny, my manifest destiny. This is why I came onto Psychic Vampires, to try to spread the energy. And if I'm lying, I'm dying, you know? So that's what it's all about. Now, I hope I made myself very clear. And if you like my presentation style, what I'd like you to do is create a whole bunch of sock accounts and just give me as many hits as possible because I have some real ego issues, some real problems. You want to get back up, Kitty? You're running off? Why? Are you scared? It's because you heard Ron's song and never touched that cat. I never did. That made me feel really bad. It hurt my feelings. Ma, shut up. I'm on it. It's CW. Quit saying that. Hi, my secretary. Anyway, I just wanted to say.
Benjamin, when you were born, what's wrong with you?
You see.
CW, Smee-W.
It's negative energy, Ma. It's negative energy. So, anyways, I just want to talk about, you know, if you, I'm demonstrably talking about J. Essex and the Commonwealth of Ranting. So I hope I've made myself clear, and I hope this has been very informative to you, and I love you all. Okay. And fuck you, Omni, you piece of shit. And I love you, but I'm cursing you and hope that really bad stuff happens to you so you'll come around and forget to shave or, you know, even have, like, proper, you know, hygiene and so forth, because then you will understand the Commonwealth of Ranting.
Oh, the break's over. Is Ron back yet? I have a feeling the answer's no.
Why don't you ever pressure Doc to come back? Oh, is Doc back yet? Huh?
Punching bag,
dude. It's because I'm always here and I never sleep.
Yeah, I'm not asleep
either. Who would ever attack Doc? You're so much the better target, Ron.
Yeah, yeah. Well.
You're like the pink fuzzy underbelly.
I like being pink and fuzzy. That's cute.
Sounds, wet.
That sounds adorable.
Smelly like fish.
Mmm. Tasty. Long John Silver's belly.
Ron, why are you distracting us? I hear that the writer's muse leveled a response to the doc while we were on break.
Oh, go for it, man. What'd she say?
You know, I had to say, she's just posting on the same thread, so I think it's reasonable to comment about it. But yeah, a lot happened, and it's kind of the same, but a little bit more interesting, because, like I said, I'm done engaging with this person.
Doesn't she accuse us of a very specific act?
Well, let's scroll down and have a little look at it. And
I haven't even read the comment yet, but it looks fucking hilarious. It's a comment to Radish Department, who is an amazing fan. We love you, Radish Department.
Yeah, Radish Department's
whoever
awesome.
You are.
Friend of the show.
Friend of the show. Radish
Department. I always get the best of radishes from there.
Do you want me to read it, or do you want to read it, Doc?
Yeah, you should do it. You should do it, because I'm not funny.
I'll read it in my best Amy voice. Okay. There's no need to keep taunting. No one has to answer you. I am not going to. This is a terrible impression of Amy, by the way, but just go with it.
By the way, the question that was asked is, do you believe Patrick John Coleman's claim that Michael murdered Vitaly?
All right, so this is the answer.
It's a pretty simple question. I don't believe his claim.
Because I know whatever will be used. Because I know whatever I say, it will be used against me relentlessly, twisted, and then used to harass me at every opportunity. Whether police have or have not been contacted is not your business. Bitch, it's my business! If he's accusing me of fucking murder, then it's my business if he contacts the goddamn police. And in fact, I heavily encourage his ass to call the police and tell them this information.
And how about this? If you don't believe that Michael killed Vitaly, then how would saying no be used to twist something around and do this and that? Are you trying to say Patrick would do that to you,
Amy,
if you said no?
Fuck yourself, you disgusting piece of garbage. That's what you are. You're a sick, twisted bitch. If you're really going to perpetuate this fucking lie that I did what Patrick says I did, fuck yourself, okay? Well, let's continue to read her stupid-ass comment. Oh, man, I have to scroll back up. Sorry, scrolling, because it's a long comment. Okay, whether police have or have not been contacted is not your business. And if police have been contacted, who would be stupid enough to broadcast that anyway? Didn't Patrick broadcast a fucking message of him calling the police and put it on speakerphone? So if your question is who would be stupid enough to broadcast their contact to the police, your answer is Eric Durkholz, you fucking dumb bitch.
If I recall correctly, he's done that exactly 3 times.
Multiple times.
Yeah.
Mm. I love potato chips.
Yeah, but dude, you have to get the meat is yet to come there.
All right. Do you really think people are that stupid? Yes, we've seen Patrick literally be that fucking stupid. So yes, if Patrick called the police on me, I guarantee that there would be a phone call. And you know what? I want him to call the police on me. I desperately hope that he does call the police saying that I killed Vitaly because he fucking made it up. He's repeating shit that was told to him by 2 specific retards. And I would love for the police to know that this is a goddamn crazy man who just says whatever assholes on the internet tell him to say. I would love for them to know that. So obviously he has not contacted the police. But continuing. Someone spray painted pedophile in large letters on the side of his building directly across from his apartment, right for him to see when he walks out. $10 that this piece of shit did it himself. I mean, I bet he spray painted that shit himself.
Of course.
How stupid are you?
Every time he accuses somebody of vandalizing his fucking home, you see that he's done it himself.
Yeah. You know what, Amy? You're a stupid fucking blood bag. You're just a supply for this fucking moron. How do you not understand it? How long has he been using you? How long has he been taking your money? How long has he been fucking manipulating you? You just believe every stupid ass thing he says? You don't know yet what he's capable of? Then fuck you, you stupid ass bitch. It's your own fault that you're a moron. It's not our fucking fault.
If you're this dumb, you almost deserve to have your mind fucked by him.
Seriously, you fucking deserve to be abused by this fucking asshole.
Oh, it gets better. It gets better, guys.
All right, let's see. His apartment was broken into the last time he was in the hospital, and his computer was stolen along with his hard drive. $10, this piece of shit smashed his computer because he was afraid of the evidence the police would find on it. Fucking bet that's exactly what happened.
That wouldn't work anyway, but he's a fucking retard that would think it would.
How many times do we got to catch this fucking loser in a goddamn blatant lie before this dumb bitch realizes that she's being lied to? I mean, Amy, how stupid are you? How do you like to be a fucking moron? Do you like to be a rube? Do you like to be a prop in his fucking narcissistic play? Is that what gets you off? Do you enjoy being the second stringer in his little fucking bullshit spot? Whatever. Oh my god.
She does.
I'm really outraged. She
likes to be, off on it.
She likes to be the extra in the movie.
She's really loving getting this attention too, I bet. She's a fucking
goddamn
idiot,
Amy. I don't care what you've gone through. I don't care what you say. This piece of shit's been revealed over and over again as a domestic abusing, drug abusing, goddamn lying con artist over and over again. Anyone who denies the evidence at this point is a goddamn idiot. And so what do you think that makes you, Amy?
I mean, the people that have survived his bullshit have told us that the same stuff over and over that he abuses people, god damn it.
Here's more.
And if you seriously are willing to just sit by and be complacent with that, then you're fucked up.
No, she thinks it's right for people to be abused because it brings about their spiritual development. So if you think that, then you can go fuck yourself, okay, everyone who thinks that? But let's continue with her stupid ass rant.
Oh yeah, this brace yourselves and strap in.
Let's get real crazy. Interesting that nothing else was taken besides his cell phone. Are they trying to plant child porn evidence on his computer hard drives? Are you kidding me, bitch? You think that we're actually hiring people to steal his cell phone and computer to plant child porn? Is he the one that's telling you this crap? Because if he's telling you this, then there's a very good chance that it's actually on his cell phone and computer. I mean, how stupid are you?
I wouldn't doubt it, actually. We've heard about his fondness of pornography as it is.
We know he likes 14-year-old boys.
That's true. We're just asking questions here, just very much like you.
She says, yeah. We are that desperate. Lady, okay. How much fucking money do you think we have that we can hire people to fucking break into Patrick Coleman's apartment, steal his cell phone and computer, to plant incriminating evidence on it, then why doesn't he just report the theft to the police right now? If he did that, if the computer was ever recovered with the information, then they could clearly pin it on us. But he's not reporting it to the police because it was not stolen, you fucking idiot!
And Amy, you don't seem willing to answer the question about Michael's murder accusation.
Yeah, why not, bitch?
And are you inferring by this that you think we're involved in a criminal conspiracy to break and enter and larceny?
I'll tell you, because she doesn't care, Doc. She thinks that she can lie and say whatever she wants about us because for whatever reason, she loves Patrick. So she doesn't care if she lies about us and slanders us for trying to find justice for a dead fucking boy. Fuck you, bitch! Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, I'm
not to mention, like, there's a child pornography fucking law there, too, that she's accusing us of breaking.
Who mentioned child pornography? Who mentioned that before Amy mentioned it? Did any of us say that Patrick has that crap on his computer? None of us said that.
Apparently, she heard it straight from him. Stupid bitch. I swear to fucking God.
It makes me wonder what he's telling her. Is he paranoid? Is he paranoid that the police will catch him and find that shit?
Why would he ever bring that shit up? No one's ever played that angle. Anytime we ever spoke of anything like that is when he's like talking about having this 14-year-old boy come visit him and he'll be his uncle Amy, we never said anything about him having child pornography, you crazy bitch.
When Amy tries to defend Patrick, she makes him look so much more fucking guilty. Hey, Patrick, for your own fucking self-preservation, you need to cut this bitch loose. She's making you look bad, okay?
Yeah, she's giving away your inner sanctum here. It's talking about your fear of having child porn appear on your computer somehow, just magically, right?
Makes you wonder what he's getting up to. That he's paranoid, we'll find out.
Guys,
this is crazy.
This is good, but you're digging in the tires, and you really need to scroll on with this. Because
yeah, you're right. We need to finish.
Some amazing stuff.
I'm sorry. Well, these potato chips are delicious. So, Lay's potato chips, everyone.
Or I could read a little bit if you want.
You can read. Go ahead. Where do we stop? I'm boring.
You know, you guys are funny. So I'm not going to do the voice, but
we
continue.
They are that desperate. So you can continue from there.
Look at the lengths they've already gone to. Michael has spewed it over and over and over in video evidence that he wants to see Patrick in jail. Yeah, for the crimes that Patrick commits on video.
He's a criminal. He fucking admits that he's a criminal and he rubs our goddamn faces in it. So what sane person wouldn't want to see? I just spit potato chips everywhere. What sane person wouldn't want to see this piece of shit locked up in jail?
How dare you be an upstanding citizen to want to actually see the law upheld when it comes to dangerous assholes like Patrick? How dare you?
But we shouldn't pay any attention to him because there are worse people in the world.
Can someone explain that logic to me?
Is there any explanation that makes that work? Let's
continue on with her brilliant comment.
He will stop at nothing. That's you, Michael. Patrick John Coleman is a targeted individual being targeted by the organized gang stalkers, calling
themselves
psychic vampires. we're three guys. We live like 4,000 miles apart.
Uh-huh.
And we talk twice a week and text occasionally. Organized a gang of three. Yeah, bollocks.
Yeah, we're gang stalkers.
Mm-hmm, there you go. I am not afraid to state the truth and to stand up. If you want to start threatening and harassing me, then come at me.
Hey, Amy, you're not afraid to state the truth, why don't you just come on this goddamn podcast and answer some fucking questions?
Or not even do that, just answer the questions in the first place. People have been asking you shit in comments, and you won't reply to any of it. You just dodge it like a scared bitch.
Like I say, it's like...
You know where that rabbit hole will lead, and it's going to make you look stupid. And you're afraid to look stupid, but you already do, so just come on.
Yeah, and there have been times in my life where I had sympathy for Patrick, and then I learned a little bit more about the guy. And I wish him a recovery and a long and happy life.
Yeah, not same here.
Damaging people, not damaging people, and knowing he's doing it by telling them bullshit about medicine. So, yeah.
You guys may very well wish Patrick a long and happy life, but it's not a consensus. Okay. Just throwing that out.
Omni's Minority Report.
That's right. It's yeah, okay if so only one of us says that.
Just I have a final word on this. The final sentence is, if you want to start threatening and harassing me, then come at me. No, I don't, and I wouldn't, and I won't be coming at you, because there's no point in having a conversation, because you don't respond to reason.
Well, guys,
and it's tragic.
No, she's totally batshit insane. She loves Charles Manson, but refuses to ever talk about her love for Charles Manson. And when defending Patrick, she refuses to answer any questions about him. But, guys, we got about an hour and a half left. Do you want to get to some fresh tards? I mean, we did promise people.
Yeah.
Promise.
You drunk bastard.
Shut up, Ron. Don't promise. You ruin the show by changing the focus to my drunkenness.
Omni, you're a drunk. I know all about you.
I know who you are.
Yeah. You're a drunk. Meh.
Oh my god, I'm so upset. Oh, you figured it out.
Yeah. You're a drunk. You're a big mean. You guys are so mean. I don't know why I hang out with you.
Yeah, you're way better than us, to be honest with you, Doc. What are you doing here?
Well, apparently I'm playing Mr. Nice Guy as some kind of complex nefarious plan.
Is the Illuminati using us for nefarious purposes, and you're the way that they're using us?
He's our CIA handler.
The fact of the matter is that that could be the case, and maybe it isn't. But, yeah, Writer's Muse commented that I play Mr. Nice Guy. Like, there's a kind of good cop, bad cop,
yeah.
Massive conspiracy. And did you know that Shaman Watch is like a neighborhood watch thing?
Oh, yeah, totally, totally. There's the three of us. And that's pretty much it. But yeah, it's totally a neighborhood watch.
Oh yeah, a whole community communicates to Infro and contributes to this.
But I wanted to comment specifically about that because it was the one thing that I could really agree with. Yeah, it's exactly like that because this forum is a community involving real people, and Patrick is knowingly doing harm to at least some of them.
And you know what? A lot of these people have actually been abused and manipulated by people who were not too fucking different from Patrick in the past. So, yeah, of course they know what you're up to because it's been done to them before, you asshole.
And to reiterate, it's exactly like Neighborhood Watch. And if Patrick was in my neighborhood publicly displaying exactly what he does on video, I would still intervene. So it's a perfect analogy.
Well, all I want to say is, where are you, Amy? No, haven't heard anything from you about joining the show. So, just want to remind
you. Come on, the show and don't answer any questions.
Yeah, come on. Just show us who you are. You want to talk about how you're going to beat us and destroy us. The best way to do that would be to face us head on, right?
Show us those mental gymnastics while you're here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As but you know what? Interesting question.
I will say, nobody takes her fucking seriously anyway. So, who gives a shit?
Yeah.
Come on and,
We gave you the opportunity, you crazy fucking bitch.
Come on and fail to defend your indefensible position.
Well. Fun times.
Yeah. Let's move on to some fun and games.
Guys, we have so much, and we talked so much about Amy and CW. So, we have plenty to choose from here. We have Krista Raisa with 50 starseed products. We have a crazy bitch who brainwashes her babies about Anunnaki reptilians. We have an alien. We have a white German guy who thinks that all white people are aliens, and he's a tall white alien.
Yeah, that
one we have
good.
To watch.
Yeah.
We have to watch him tonight.
Can we do really good? Can we do maybe three or four starseed products? Because I'm really intrigued.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's do Krista Raisa. Let's do Tall White Draco, dude, for sure, and then we'll see where to go from there. What do you guys think? Do you want to do Krista or Tall White Alien?
Tall White Alien.
Yeah, okay.
Oh,
Tall White Alien.
I'm Okay, well, Doc is being... We'll do Krista right after, okay, Krista? So hold your panties, okay?
Choke on them.
We're coming for you, biatch. Old Vampy's gonna come suck your blood, bitch. All right, here we go. Can you guys see Tall White Draco? Does he not dress like an extra from the movie Dark City?
Don't say Draco.
This guy thinks all white people are aliens, which we are, right, guys? We're all white men. We all know that we're fucking aliens, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yep. We just don't talk about it. It's too controversial.
It's too much.
Here we go. Let's listen to our new friend. I don't remember his name. I can find his name while we look at it.
Greetings, my human friends. This is Rudolf of Germany. It's called White Alien. Today, I would like to make an announcement of high importance for the ones who have not been able to be selected and possibly chosen.
Okay.
The DNA enhancement work we have started on the 1st of September after the hair sample.
Did you guys see him lick his lips? Only a reptilian would do something like that. Mm-hmm. I love the getup too. It's really cool. He wears this outfit in every video.
Where the fuck did you even find this guy?
I don't know how I found it, Ron, but it came to me.
Nice. Maybe Jesus sent it to you.
Jesus, yeah, he sent it to me.
Nice find for sure. This guy's amazing. Take a look at his
videos. Let's take a look at his videos, then we'll get back to this. Oh, let me pull it up. Let me do a share screen. Here we go. Rudolf of Germany. How the Clintons plan to survive the looming nuclear war. Emergency call to Vladimir Putin. How to avoid World War III, the gold ruble. Rudolf, the tall white alien.
Vladimir Putin.
Nope. Aleister Crowley house visit.
Weird, man.
And Clinton war plans. Number 198. There's one where he says that no white people are human. All white people are aliens. Kill the slave inside of yourself.
Germany, if you're watching, can you please explain this guy for us?
Here's one. The Mandela effect endangers your mental health. Well, at least he got one thing right.
Yeah.
Religion is the enemy of freedom. Alien discloses the secret of God. This guy, Rudolf, you are so invited to a future episode of Psychic Vampires. Come on, dude.
That would be pretty cool. Come on, man. We'll be nice.
You know what? We could never get Dark Christian on because of his technical difficulties, but we want Rudolf of Germany.
Oh, man. Imagine the two of them in the same room.
Look at this one. You are a potential mass murderer.
All right.
To my channel.
Is that the name of it? Seriously? Yeah. You're a potential mass murderer. Welcome to my channel.
If right. You can see this video, you are in deadly danger. Massively high amount of views compared to his usual videos for that one.
Well, thank you, guy, I guess.
Doc, do you live in the wrong dimension?
Almost certainly. Yeah, it's certainly every Wednesday.
Me too. 10 rules to escape death. I know, once I watch this video, I'm no longer afraid to die because I know that I'll never die. This is another one. 10 steps to become superhuman. Suicide bombers are remote-controlled hybrids. Oh, this guy.
What would you do if, like, you just woke up in the middle of the night and he's standing there in that getup, like, come with me. You're the chosen one. We have to save them.
I would shoot him in the face. Here's one. The Almighty is a tall white alien. Now, I can't find the video yet, but Rudolf claims that no white people are aliens, so he believes that he is an alien, and thus, from the title of this video, he believes that God is a tall white person.
Boy, that's certainly fucking not controversial at all. This guy's the best. God is a tall white man.
Yep,
we have to get this guy on, man.
No controversy.
We need to get this guy on with Lord Josh.
Oh my God, that would be cool.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I want to get Lord Josh versus Lord Steven. That would be a battle of the lords. It would be amazing. And you know Steven would clearly fucking win.
Yeah, but he'd fucking mop the floor with him, dude. Yeah,
he would make Josh piss himself and delete all his videos from the internet. All right. Here's more tall white Rudolph.
Of several hundred people have been sent in. The selection of the people.
That code is from a Halloween costume.
By the postal system. Because once our adversaries, the other group of extraterrestrial beings,
the Pleiadians,
by the way, also the same group who has been protecting and leading Hillary Clinton.
So the aliens give a shit about Trump versus Clinton.
Hair samples to us.
Half the aliens are on Trump's side, and the other half are on Hillary's side. That seems likely.
Yeah, they're torn just like, you know. They got like red star systems and blue star systems.
Yeah, and they're all right up their assholes.
Yeah.
What do you think, Doc? Does this guy look like a real alien to you?
He's a pretty good impersonation of one. I mean, is he meant to be one of the Anunnaki lads or one of the short gray guys? I'm the Draconians. I get confused. Or maybe he's a blue avian.
Oh, the blue avians. Oh, I forgot about them for a second.
Yeah, and Howard the Duck. Isn't that Ivan Teller's go-to?
Yeah, Ivan Teller channeled Howard the Duck once.
Oh my God. I've never seen that one. I need to really go watch that.
It's a classic.
Why? What is he doing, man?
He's retarded. That's the problem.
He's hilarious.
I just wonder, why do the aliens dress in black overcoats? Dude, you're clearly a white dude. Why are you dressing in the overcoat so you don't show us your alien body? You don't have an alien body, bitch!
I am an alien. I have no lack of, or I have no sense of how to dress like a normal human being.
Troll or not a troll! What do you think?
Man. I don't care. I want to see this guy. I want to see Lord Josh and Yogi Zen all sitting around the same bowl of hummus. I'd give my right leg for it. Yogi Zen, come out wherever you are if you're still with us.
He's died from piss starvation.
Those three, the power of three, I think that would be like the nexus.
Well, Ron, what do you think? Troll or not a troll?
I'm leaning towards troll, but...
Me too.
It's hard to say. Like, well, does he get like a lot of views on these? I know he has a lot of videos, it looks like.
There's a ton of videos. Let me check the views. He gets a few thousand views per video. Not bad.
It could be just a really dedicated troll, but who knows? Yeah.
I think he probably is, but I think about two-thirds of his fans don't think that he is.
Yeah, I want to kind of like read his comment section. I bet that's a hoot.
I just don't know why he dresses like an extra from Dark City. I mean, what are you, a troll, or are you just a really insane retard? Which is it? I mean, I could see it going either way.
It's like if your dad tried to dress up like Morpheus from The Matrix.
I am a tall white alien.
Hey, son, I'm going as Morpheus this Halloween. What do you think of this outfit?
Looks like shit. All right.
Dad, Morpheus didn't wear a gay fedora.
All right, more. Here we go, more.
Some of them got sent back.
Two dimensions. The Holocaust was a hoax.
Sein Juden were really aliens.
Sein Juden were not real. Was Illuminati propaganda?
But eventually we got 119 participants to join our selected brotherhood of over 4,000 human hybrids. We have had planned to give this chance to many more people. Hence, we also give out the pyramid papers, which are a special ink, which will seep into the bloodstream of the participants, the ones who have in their possession the pyramid paper.
Why does the ink need to seep into their bloodstream? Who gives a flying fuck? Isn't the paper the only thing that matters? Who gives a shit if it's in their fucking bloodstream?
This dude's making me, like, go into a hypnotic trance.
You aren't unst aliens. You are unst white aliens, tall white dragost.
He listens to a lot of craft work, I bet.
Oh my god, that's perfect, Ron. That's perfect! Yeah, he does. And his favorite David Bowie album is Low from 1977. Yeah.
Eating crackers and cheese, guys.
You suck my dick, Ron. Gotta ruin the show with your munching on shit. Fuck you, bitch!
Well, sorry.
I'm eating chips, but nobody can hear me because I'm much better at this than you.
Well, I have teeth. I don't gum my fucking stuff to death.
You know what? Some people love, they really appreciate gumming. So,
oh, I know. I can appreciate a gumming, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Cool story, bro.
So anyways, about this German guy again?
Is he boring you guys? You want to move on to somebody else, or you want to continue with...
I want to see Starseed crap.
Dude, I thought this guy was going to be amazing, and yet I sit here bored.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought this guy was a star.
He's not very animated. Like, he just kind of... I am the alien.
Holocaust, unst, not happen, unst, fraud, hoax, unst.
Sein Juden were really holograms from the spaceship.
I don't want to, you know, I don't want to fall into a racial or cultural stereotype, but he's very serious. And yeah, very serious, not too funny.
I get it. We'll get to Krista Raisa. That's what everyone's waiting for. Everyone is just like, oh my god, we can't wait for the Krista Raisa video. That's what everyone's thinking right now.
Oh, yeah. Flicking that yeasty bean.
Oh, shut up. That's Teal Swan. Although Krista Raisa could also have a yeasty bean. Who knows?
Don't say that word.
Hey, we can say yeasty bean. YouTube's algorithms will never pick up what we mean by yeasty bean. Now, if we said dirty, bitchy, whore, cunt, YouTube's algorithms would definitely catch it. But if we say yeasty bean, YouTube will never figure it out.
You gotta watch out for that dirty, bitch, whore, cunt stuff.
Not that we would ever say that about Krista Raisa. All right. Here we go. Are you guys ready for dirty, yeasty bean?
Oh, yeah.
Dirty yeast.
Roll that big, beautiful yeasty bean footage.
Smells like a fucking bakery in this bitch.
Time to make the donuts. Writer's
switch. The non-existent desk that she doesn't have because she can't afford one.
I found out there is a DNA code called Anuli, which is French for board up. This is a first world problem. This is mainly
so anyway, bitch.
Have a job, kind of settled, and maybe just need an extra creative boost. Starseed product idea. This could be your permission slip to find a pattern and just get it done.
Why are you wearing foundation that is darker than your actual skin? Why? You're white!
This is like blackface. Do you know how racist you're being right now, Krista?
Yeah, dreadlocks and blackface, Krista Raisa. Don't blame it on being a starseed.
More like Krista Racista.
Why is she appropriating black culture? Why? And what is this word on her wall? Karatever? What is Karatever? What does that mean? It doesn't mean shit. And you actually paid for a lava lamp. What the fuck?
When she was meditating and shitting on the toilet, the word just popped into her head.
Karatever. Good job, Krista. And I love your glasses. You know what's funny? The most funny thing about your video is that you're a white person trying to appear like you're not white. Jesus Christ. That bronzer's ridiculous. You don't live in New Jersey. Stop acting like it.
Alright, number one, laminated downloads sheet. You get a laminator, make a collage of all the spiritual downloads that you have and turn it into something that makes sense.
If your skin is not really that dark, don't put on makeup to make yourself appear darker, because that's racist, you dog.
She's just trying to get that melanin magic going is all.
Hey guys, my husband's black and that magically also turned me black.
She's channeling it. That's it. That's the answer. She's channeling.
She's channeling it. Now she's African.
Emotional ebook. You can add photos. It can just be text only, however you want. That can be a giveaway with your newsletter.
This biatch is from Finland, okay? You really think this is what she looks like? Holy shit, you're the Rachel Dolezal of Finland. Take off that wig. That's fake. Show us what you really look like. You're not black, okay? You are white as snow. Just admit it. Stop putting on bronzer to make yourself look darker. It's fucking weird.
Oh, maybe that's what it is.
It's chakra makeup. She has the soul of a black person. So
yeah, she's rubbing that black face. She's rubbing that soul chakra all over herself.
Again, you are from Finland, okay? And both of your parents are white. And you are putting on makeup to make your skin appear darker than it naturally is. Do you have no shame, Krista?
No way, sister. I was black.
Does she not have any shame whatsoever? This bitch is dropping rhymes about me having a Caucasian barber. You are not black!
You're Caucasian, you stupid bitch. Look at you.
God, I hate you. Actually, I do kind of like her. There's something about me that likes her.
But you know, she has no shame. She's selling chakra makeup. Get stuff.
Retarded. Yeah, this is an item for starseeds that's going to sell. Chakra makeup. That's going to be big.
What the fuck do you even... I don't even know. Fuck it.
I'm going to sell you a unicorn cozy as well. Like a nice all-weather cover for your leprechauns.
And it's got organite crystals sewn into it. That's going to protect you from aliens.
This lady puts on makeup to make her skin look darker, but but I'm a horrible person. You're ridiculous, Krista. You're fucking ridiculous. You're a joke. You know that, right?
Different colors, and you name it according to the chakra, so it's also intelligent makeup. Universal stamps. You can now create your own stamps, I believe, on ZazzleCon.
Universal stamps. I hear a large calling from starseeds for that. Universal stamps.
Does that mean you can send a postcard to, like, the astral realm or something?
That's what it means.
Oh, my fucking God. Just kill me now.
Your letters to Santa Claus will finally arrive, everyone.
Fucking Christ, it's so stupid, it hurts.
Okay, this next one says conscious tote bag.
Oh my God. Tell me that's not real. She's not actually
Quit, Krista, quit. This is embarrassing. delete your channel. This is fucking humiliating.
Why? Why, woman? Why are you doing this?
This lady charges a lot of money for her psychic bullshit. She does not, it's not cheap to talk to her.
That's what we have to focus on. She's entertaining, though.
I do.
I want a conscious tote bag.
I do like her. I will admit, there's something that I like about her. But her
secretly attracted to.
Her husband's extremely creepy, though.
Maybe your Autover is like her new clothing line brand.
I'm autistic, just like. Never mind.
Shut
Never
up.
Mind.
You shut your mouth right now.
I'll shut up.
We
Everybody else
this.
Is being quiet, so I'll be quiet too.
We fucking talked about this, man.
I talked about it, bitch! I don't know. Are you guys ready for more Krista?
Yeah.
Just tote bags. I just have to make some tote bags at some point. Political stickers. If you have...
Political stickers. Star seeds love them.
Oh, that's a shame. I thought she was really talking about like a tote bag with sentience. You know,
maybe she was. Maybe she was. Ron?
Yeah.
Do you have anything to say?
I think she's fucking lost her goddamn mind.
Can you drag that out for 30 seconds while I take a piss?
I mean, I don't know what she's trying to do. Like, this feels like it's a parody, but I know it's not. She's actually this fucking stupid to think this is going to work.
And who knows? This may be her income. And I'm kind of in two minds about it because it's all bullshit, but it's relatively benign bullshit. Although, doesn't she charge like $100 or something for, you know, chakra alignments?
Oh, yeah, she does, like, counseling and all this other bullshit, just like Patrick does.
Well, I mean, in her instance, I haven't heard her talking about psychiatric medication or anything really of substance. So I'm kind of leaning towards probably a nut job, probably not a big risk to people.
I'm sure if you prodded her on the subject, she would probably say that, yeah, the psychiatric industry's horrible, don't take drugs, just call me, probably. And that's just my guess. You need to get galactivated, man. That's all.
Galactivated and the DNA and the it's not heavy water. It's some other vibe thing that she does.
Yeah, galactivation.
This person said that while she was at the Ghostbusters reboot in the theater and eating a shitload of popcorn, she began to develop psychic pains in her stomach. From the feminists in the audience who are experiencing some kind of psychological trauma because of the fucking power that men have over women. So yeah. While eating a giant bucket of movie theater popcorn and experiencing stomach pains, her first reaction was that maybe it's psychic trauma because of feminism. So that's who this person is, okay? This person who's wearing bronzer that makes her appear much darker than she naturally appears.
I mean, who the fuck does that? Is she? I can't believe she's doing this. Was she always this stupid, or is she just getting worse?
I have a feeling that the second she married this fucking loser, Arcturus Raw, her life began to enter an enormous downward spiral. I just have a feeling.
What's he been up to lately anyway? I haven't been keeping an eye on him.
It's impossible to review his videos because he started to incorporate his own music into the videos so that he can copyright flag anyone who uses his music.
Oh, God.
I mean, it's fucking devious. This guy is not an idiot. He knows exactly what he's fucking doing.
Oh, dickhead.
Well, yeah. There you go. You guys
want to
do more
Crystal
or whatever? You
want to
move on?
Whatever. Yeah, sure. Let her play on. It's funny.
Okay. Let's see what her next product idea is. I'm sure it's going to blow us all right out of the water.
watercolor and a little booklet of postcards. You can already start making postcards, then turn your art into stickers, because everybody loves stickers. An art brochure that you print from home with a cool color, and then you fold it up, explaining some how-to. Resell your homegrown plants if you have.
I want to squirt her in the face with a hose and see, like, what part of her skin is white and what part the bronzer remains on, just so we can compare and contrast.
Yeah. Quick question. How old is this lady, like, approximately?
My guess is early 20s, but I don't really know for sure. She could be 500.
She sounds like she's 9. And you do the thing and blah, 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 and the spirits and fairies and chakra makeup. Yes, dear. Have a cookie.
The Little Mermaid is also real.
I'll sell plants to people. They're starseed plants.
They're, you know what? I would buy weed from her. If I bought weed, which I do not do because weed is illegal. That would be a good starseed product idea. Number 9, weed. Oh, wait.
I bet she would sell it under weight anyway.
Homegrown plants is kind of weed. Yeah.
That's the best one.
What up, homie? I got some homegrown. Would you like to purchase some marijuana?
Yeah.
Market, sell it to your neighbors. Put some outside for $5. Pink light bulbs or glitter light bulbs even.
Pink light bulbs. That's going to be a huge seller for starseeds. There's a huge demand for pink light bulbs among the starseed demographic.
What? Pink light bulbs? This bitch is fucking nuts.
No, this is a trolling video. Some of her videos are trolling, and some of them are serious. But she thinks by doing the trolling videos, it somehow alleviates
her retardation.
Yeah, exactly. So when she's talking about the psychic pains at the Ghostbusters movie, if you think she's a retard, she goes, "Well, look at my trolling videos. You don't know when I'm being serious or not. But guess what, bitch? We know. We know when you're for real."
Yeah, you're not that clever.
Yeah, you're not fucking complex. Come on.
Chakra makeup. Please.
I don't know, right?
Pink light bulbs.
Yeah, I need an extra lens in my glasses for the old third eye here.
Krista! Krista, go back to your parents and beg for help. You're clearly way over your head. You need to let your parents know you married a crazy cult leader and he's trying to brainwash you. Go to your parents, tell them that you don't know what to do, and I promise they will help. Okay? Just get out of this.
Just tell them that your husband's making you panhandle on the internet and pretend you got superpowers, and you're really scared and want to come home.
You're extremely embarrassed by the things you've had to do for money, which, while not prostitution, are in many ways very similar.
Absolutely.
Ugh. Yeah.
If you're flogging chakra makeup, your dignity's at a low ebb there, sister. And we love you, and we love everyone, and we want you to do well and get some help.
And stop wearing blackface, you retard.
Yeah, that's racist! I hope some black woman just is like, "What the fuck, bitch?" and punches her right in her face.
Bitch, who the fuck you think you is? Rachel Dolezal? Slaps the fuck out of her.
Where are you from, bitch? Finland? Pah! Fuck you. Alright.
Let's move on.
Mm-hmm.
So many more tards. And we wasted so much time talking about CW Ranter. What do we got? Guys, we have the Rote something Institute. What's it called? I don't remember. God, I already forgot.
You're drunk.
We have, yeah, Ron knows this one. We have Erica Agnew. Oh my God, Danielle Agnew. Oh my God, too much shitty wine already. I forgot. We have spiritualawakenings.net. What do you guys want to do?
There's a lot to choose from. I don't know. You should show that Rode Institute one. That bitch is nuts.
Yeah, that one's pretty good. Rode Institute.
That's hilarious.
I have a feeling that they seem like the kind of people who would falsely flag a video for copyright violations.
Just don't put their name in the title or anything.
Oh, I won't put it in the title, but this is the Rode Institute, everyone. It is total blatant hypnotization. I don't know what's going on with the music, so I guess we'll just mute the music while we play through this. The transmission you are about to experience was originally a Facebook post that went viral. I received over 300 private messages by the second day from people on every single continent pouring out of their life stories to me. Some shared that they had received this message and they were relieved to know that they were not alone. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, still going on.
Don't forget the screen share.
Oh, you guys can't see it?
Uh-uh.
Why don't you suck my dick, Ron? Why do you got to point out all of my fucking flaws, bitch?
Well, I'm just saying. It would be beneficial if we could see who the fuck we're talking about.
Why don't you suck my big dick? What do you think of that?
How about no?
Yeah, you're going to do it. We all.
You keep asking me over and over, and I'm just not into you, man.
Hey!
I think you could probably get there if you had to.
Maybe you've been...
Here we go. Let's go. Let's go back. This one's for Ron.
Welcome. If you find yourself here listening to these words, this transmission, you are meant to be here.
It's still some screen sharing.
Maybe you've been... Sharing,
oh, it stopped screen sharing. That is so gay! This is CW Chandler's fault.
Just stop being gay for a second while you click play and it should work.
Shut up!
Seeing number codes. Maybe you've been hearing about twin flames or reading spiritual books. Maybe you've been seeing 144 and 411, all of these number codes. If not, you will now. Maybe you just...
You will now! If you never saw them before, now that I've subconsciously implanted the impulse into you using my completely fucking blatantly hypnotic video, then you'll start to see it now!
It's the dumbest shit ever.
Oh, she's so fucking full of crap.
Wanna be cult leader, like she looks like she's in a dentist's office.
She really does.
I messed up. Oh, don't leave me, Ron. I'm sorry, Ron.
They're fucking fake like plant.
Up from a deep sleep, starting to remember after suffering from amnesia. Whether you're new to the path or you've been on the path for years makes no difference. If you're awakening...
Because it's all bullshit.
Everything I'm talking about is made up.
This transmission is for you!
This is like the most brainless, mindless fluff strung together that I've ever seen.
I want to meet the idiot who's emotionally affected by this. Like, I want to meet the moron who actually watches this video and goes, "Oh my god, my eyes are finally open.
My heart is exploding with love for the planet. I want to fuck the world.
I see the number codes now."
Yeah, but it's...
I see this, 411 it's... everywhere. I love 311. That's my favorite band. Amber is the color of your energy. Oh.
This is the intellectual and sophistication sifter. You know, if you buy into this, I'm probably going to get you to shell out some bucks.
Yeah.
By telling you that, you know, we need to buy a new spaceship by tomorrow. And, you know, anything goes once you come through this nonsense.
Dude, it's a litmus test. It's like, are you really retarded or not? Well, what do you think of this video?
Yeah, just like the flat earth. You can convince someone of that.
Flat earth. Dude, okay. I was like, when I started my new channel, I was like, oh, let's check out some of the subjects we looked at before. I looked up flat earth.
And there's like a secret hangout of Patricia Steer and all these flat earth idiots like Nathan Oakley. And they're all talking about drinking pee for a really long time. And they're flagging people down for copyright violations. They're using false DMCAs to stop people from spreading this supposedly secret hangout where they talk about how great it is to drink pee.
Like, wow.
Wow, your life has reached a serious low. I mean, that is not cool, man.
I mean, dude, not only are you doing that, but you're meeting up with other people to talk about doing it.
Yeah, and then you're censoring people who expose you talking about it.
Fucking crazy. I'm
just imagining an AA meeting, you know? Hello, my name's Patricia, and I drink urine.
Yeah, I love drinking urine. It reminds me of when I was a child. All right, I just had
fan mail for you. I'm going to have to make a teddy bear for Omni and Ron. What? And I know what animals they'll be, okay?
What animals?
A big jackass, probably, for who knows?
For Ron! Who knows?
Not at all. Not for me.
I'm a sly fox.
You're very foxy. Yeah, fox is
that's
good.
Right.
I sexually identify as a zebra.
Zebra. There you go.
I'm a sexy dragon.
I'll pass that on.
All right, so there's going to be a picture of a dragon fucking a zebra pretty soon, Ron. Prepare yourself.
And that zebra's going to be jerking off all over your face. You just watch.
No. The picture's going to be the dragon fucking the zebra.
Nope. The zebra's going to put out the fire of your flames with its semen.
No one's going to draw a zebra penis. It's just not going to happen. I have the most likelihood to win this.
The black stripe just happens to be across my penis.
Whoever draws a picture of a dragon fucking a zebra, you win my eternal respect.
Nobody cares about your respect.
That's not right. That's nobody. Incorrect.
They're going to draw an awesome picture of this zebra fucking the shit out of a dragon. And that's cooler.
Doc, which would you prefer to see? A picture of a dragon fucking a zebra or a zebra fucking a dragon? Which is best for you?
I would worry about the zebra because dragons are all kind of spiny and stuff on the back. So I think the dragon has the top.
You son of a bitch!
I knew you were going to side with him.
You betray me in this fucking dark hour. You just turn on me to help Ron!
Yeah, I'm just exploiting you because you're a vulnerable person and you're easily manipulated.
Of a dragon fucking a zebra who is fucking an owl! Do it! Do it! Get on top of that, Catspiracy. By the way, Catspiracy, I don't know how to unban you. I have no idea. I wish I could, but I don't know how to do it. Blame Vic. It's Vic's fault.
Yeah. Friend of the show, but he does ruin everything.
He ruined not as bad as Ron ruins everything, but it's like, runner up. You know? Yeah.
Vic really fags everything up. Like he's
do really not good. Try to pin your problems on Vic. You're the one that ruins everything, Ron.
Well, I mean, nobody should have never gave this dude a wrench the way he just fires off and
I'm gonna take a wrench.
Know who she
shove
is.
It up your asshole. I'm gonna rape you with it till you bleed.
And then afterwards, he's like, oh, sorry, Catspiracy. I didn't know who you are. I'm bad.
Oh, your Vic voice is the same as your CW voice, huh?
Yeah, well, I don't know.
Do you think people who are from New York and from the Bronx sound like fucking CW chants? Are you racist? Fuck you. All right, more of this lady. I would say bitch, but I'm going to say lady instead because I'm a gentleman and she's totally not a bitch at all.
She looks really familiar to me, like I've seen her in a porno, but I can't.
I have never seen her in a porno, but you know what? I don't pay attention to females while I'm watching porn. So
Wait, am I not sharing the screen anymore? You guys can see my drunken ass face? Yes. God damn it! I thought this was showing the fucking screen share! Now I look like a dirty drunk! The writer's muse is correct about everything!
I know, you're exposing yourself, man. She's right about you, bro. She knows everything.
Man, I hope I didn't touch my dick while that was showing.
You're a degenerate. I'm ashamed to know you. And why are we doing this terrible thing?
Why?
You know?
Why are you guys doing this to me? Why are you doing this to me?
We saw you pick your nose and eat your snot, too. We all saw it.
Shut up. I don't eat my snot. I pick my nose and flick it across the room, bitch.
And that's not cool either, though.
It's way cooler than eating your own boogers.
If you say so.
Ron likes to pick the boogers out of his ass and taste them.
Right. Ew.
You're disgusting! Fuck you, Ron! This is all about how disgusting you are now.
My ass does not have mucus.
Yes, it does. You disgusting piece of garbage. Alright. It stopped sharing again! This is bullshit! God damn, the Chancellor's curse is real! I swear I did not hit stop sharing, and it just immediately stopped sharing. This is goddamn garbage. In fact, I'm so confused, I don't even know where we were at. What were we doing? Oh, we were talking about this bitch from the Road Institute. So what, did the program crash? Which one of you sons of bitches hacked my computer? Huh?
Addison, I'm looking at you, boy.
Addison? Fuck you, bitch!
No, don't say that. His kid might be listening.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't want his kid's first words to be, fuck you, CW. Forgot. Oh, this is fucking up so bad, and I really just cannot help but blame Ron. Like, everything is going wrong, and it's usually Ron's fault when this happens.
I'm just sitting here eating my crackers minding my own damn business. So
why don't you shut your crackers up your fucking ass? Why did the VLC media player crash? Who is hacking my computer right now? Now I look like an asshole because somebody's hacking my computer.
I know who it might be.
Oh yeah, who?
Yeah, I can't talk about him.
You can't say their name because the initials are E and then the letter that comes after K.
Could be.
Oh, wait, the letter that comes before K. I'm sorry. Man, the writer's muse has me pegged. I really am just a stupid drunk.
Yeah, it's a tragic thing to see all that talent just being enhanced by drink.
That's true.
Yeah.
I don't know if this is where we left off, but I sure as fuck skipped to this part, so here we go.
By the council. This is the true meaning of the Chosen Ones. We chose to come to Earth to help with the evolution of consciousness, and we were chosen by the council.
Why would the aliens possess this retard instead of just fucking coming on fucking television and showing us all? They don't have the technology to do that. They can travel through outer space. But they can't just show themselves on TV. They have to show themselves through a goddamn retard on the internet. That seems likely.
And here we go. Let's conjure four or five nebulous concepts, throw in some mythical entities, and say, you're very special.
Yeah. Also, guys, we're going to make you randomly see numbers in places for no fucking apparent reason whatsoever.
If you haven't seen those numbers, you will see them now.
Yeah. I mean, this is low-level psychology.
Just because we can do it, we're going to do it.
I love the background music. Dun 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 dun. Shut up! Turn that music off! You're terrible!
Yeah, not impressed with this shtick.
Yeah, get a real job, lady.
Well, we know one thing. Her husband's in on this crap because we've seen some other videos from her channel and he's pushing this shit too. This is a goddamn scam. If you're stupid enough to give these people one penny
then you really need to question your own judgment, okay?
Oh, yeah, it's a scammer couple, and they just go around going, hey, guys, we're going to turn you into super galactivated homies, G.
Look at our painting. It's put into actually three paintings, which means that we're spiritual. Give us money! Shut up! No one's giving you a penny. You're a scammer. You're a really bad scammer, too.
Think about my wife's boobs.
Can I ask you a question, Michael? Because someone made a comment, and I didn't want to speak for you. But they were drawing a comparison between your Patreon account, and if you haven't subscribed, go and subscribe, your Patreon account and the New Age healers, crystal workers, all that stuff, charging hundreds of dollars per hour for their bullshit.
This is goddamn ridiculous because I give an hour and a half to 2 hours of content for $5 a fucking month. And I don't promise people spiritual knowledge or any of that shit. All I do is provide some fucking entertaining content. I'm not giving people promises about the future. To say that me asking for people for $5 a month for 2 hours of content is the same as one of these fucking bitches asking for $130 to $5 for 30 minutes is goddamn ridiculous. If you're going to compare that, you're a fucking retard. I never once say that I have magic powers or that I'm going to give you anything other than some fucking content. So if you really want to try to compare it, you're a dumbass who should probably go take a long dive off a short bridge.
Yeah, like some of these people charge like $150 just to Skype with them for 10 minutes and shit. Are you fucking kidding?
And I'm not promising spiritual knowledge by any fucking measure.
So a false equivalence like that is one of the very basic logical fallacies that people jump into when they don't, in fact, have an argument to support their position.
Listen, all I know is I saw this bitch, what was her name? Crystal Ann Compton. She's charging $130. I'm kind of drunk, so maybe I'm confusing it. It was the ET Whisper. He's charging $135 for 30 minutes for him to spew his bullshit. I give you 30 minutes of fucking content for free. I don't fucking try to charge you for spiritual knowledge. And anything I charge you for is $5. I say, this is content. It's just for your entertainment. There's never a point in which I promised you any kind of knowledge or fucking spiritual empowerment by any measure. I don't lie about what I'm fucking offering you. Anyway,
I mean, you're just telling it is what it is. I mean, it's a fucking video. You can choose to pay for it.
Me rambling like
not.
A retard for 90 minutes. 40, you know.
You can choose to pay for it or not, and nobody's expecting to fucking go in there and be like, now I'm going to make decisions about my life now.
Yeah, and I expect you to be underwhelmed, okay?
Yeah, although when I watch it, I bust a gut laughing, and that's why it's a kind of interesting thing to spend $5 on, a month.
Yeah, if you like the guy fucking and you want to watch his stuff and want to support what he does, then fucking do it. If not, no problem.
I didn't pull one over on anyone. I didn't say, like, here's all my content. Oh, now I'm going to take it away unless you pay me. It's the same fucking amount of content as it ever was. I'm just offering something for a minimal $5 a month, which I'm sure you spend on goddamn candy a fucking day or whatever the fuck you buy. Who fucking knows? I mean, if you don't want to buy it, I don't give a flying fuck if you buy it or not. I'm not begging you to buy it. My income doesn't rely on you buying it. I don't give a shit.
And if anybody would prefer, you can pay me $200 an hour US, and I'll make up some bullshit.
Yeah, and Ron will fuck you. I mean, oh my God, I called you Ron.
$20 is $20.
Doc will fuck you harder and more passionately than any man has ever fucked you in your life.
Not harder than me.
Small amount of money.
So yeah, and my dark mage powers, if you need someone to tell you nonsense that they've just really made up on the spot, give me some money and I will donate all of it without any question to a charity supporting mental health recovery.
And he will still fuck you, right?
Right, Doc? That's right, it's a guarantee, even though he doesn't say it.
His silence is a silence of agreement.
It's a silent agreement.
Want to continue? Moving on.
Want to continue with the Rodents? The two?
Here we go.
Of course, this doesn't make us above anyone. In highest truth, we are all one. And it is the knowing, that we are all one. The understanding that if...
It's the understanding.
Oh God!
Shut up.
Bitch, are you serious? You're getting worked up over stupid ass aliens, bitch. What's wrong with you? She's fucking nuts, man. I swear to God.
This bitch wants an Arcturian wiener in her mouth.
She needs to go. Yeah, never mind. I was going to say something wrong.
If it comes out from inside of your body, I still want it. Man,
my pussy is so galactivated right now.
It's galactivated.
Does it galactivate the DNA sequences that do a thing? That...
Yeah, absolutely. It makes my spiral in my DNA, and it feels really good down there.
It vibrates.
Yeah. Makes my chakra explode and the waters break.
Her chakra blew out.
My chakras are really knackered at the moment. I mean,
chakra's bloody and raw right now.
She looks like she's about to. She looks like she's about to sneeze. How you pause this?
Achoo! All right. I ruined everything.
Who does this and goes? People are gonna take me seriously when I post this online.
A goddamn
retard. The people who fall through the sieve. Yep. That small population that all know each other. Because it's an organized gang.
So the bitches they really work together, huh? Man, it keeps closing out my share screen. This is the goddamn Illuminati, I'm convinced.
It's the 144,000 alien starseeds. They're fighting back, man. They're enlightened. You need to watch out. Their energy is upon us.
Background question. There are 144,000 starseeds and Jehovah's Witnesses. Are they the same group?
Well, like they're channeling Jehovah.
Yeah.
It's making sense, kind of.
I don't know. I'm just making shit up, but I mean, that's what they're doing. Makes sense, right?
Yeah, that's true. Very well said.
Anyone suffers, we all suffer. That tugged at our heartstrings in the first place, that drew us to this earthly mission. It is what called us here to serve. You could call us Earth Angels, Star Seeds.
Bitch, you are embarrassing yourself.
We're gonna start calling ourselves special names because we're so special and we don't suck.
This lady is really gonna sit there and fake cry and talk about how Star Seeds and all of this other crap exists. You are embarrassing not only yourself, but the entire human race. Aliens out there, they're watching this and they're like, what the fuck? Humans are goddamn retarded.
People pay money for this shit and she goes and bleaches her asshole with it.
Oh, for real? That's probably exactly what she does. Lady, ridiculous. You're an embarrassment to humanity.
It is fucking ridiculous.
Humans,
you should be ashamed of yourself.
Let you know that we are out there and we are watching.
Carlos said she's a horse thief.
She is. She's a dirty horse thief. And she stole a horse's face and used it for her own.
Fucking horse face thief. You're a horse face thief.
I never thought I would say this, but this lady even embarrasses other starseeds. They're sitting there going, Shut up.
Yeah, Ryan Cropper's there pretending that he has telekinesis. And he's going, shut up, bitch! You're making us look stupid! Shut your mouth! You are one of the 144,000. You will see the numbers 411 from now on. If you haven't seen them before, you will now. Shut up!
You're terrible. Start looking for those numbers, guys. Why would aliens want to communicate like that? Hey, guys, here's some random numbers. Look for this shit for no reason.
Yeah, the aliens are like, we could directly communicate because they clearly understand language, but instead let's give them cryptic messages involving numbers.
It's not even a cryptic message, though. It's just three numbers. What the fuck does that even mean? Like, ooh, aliens. Whenever you see this, it means aliens.
Hey, guys, I thought of the numbers 411. That must mean aliens are talking to me telepathically.
That's it. It's just
moron.
You know where this leads, guys? This leads straight to Blue Heaven.
Oh my
God. Thinks of three numbers. She thinks of three numbers every two or three days, and it always leads to apocalypse.
That never happens.
You know the gematria is like 411, and then like you add 9, and it spells 420, which is weed.
Okay. Cool story.
Gematria lessons.
That's what the aliens are saying. But you know what? All it would take would be a radio frequency broadcast of three or four successive prime numbers. Bingo. We know they're there. And we know that they're aware that we're numerate. It's not complicated, you know? Oh, yeah. Ooh, they talked to me through the numbers that showed up on the gas pump and the license plate. No, they didn't.
Yes, they did. Why would you deny it? You don't know they're lying. What if they're telling the truth? Why don't you just accept their word for it?
Yeah, I'll do that.
Hey, guys, there's a lot more to talk about, but what we could do instead, if you want, is just, like, talk shit about Patrick. What do you want to do?
I've kind of said what I need to say about the guy.
Oh, but there's so much to say. Maybe
focus on one or two of the videos that we've taken apart. The 14-year-old is a classic, but we've done it to death. We've analyzed every line that he said. What about the goblin defense?
Instead of Patrick, let's watch. Hold on, bitch. Shut up, bitch! I'm not ready for you! Wait, it went back? Oh my God, I don't know what's happening. I'm scared. I'm scared of what's happening with VLC Media Player right now. What's going on? This isn't what I chose.
I found out there is a DNA code called immune.
Shut up, we already watched you. No, we already watched this. This is Ron's fault. This complete disharmony that's happening right now. Robin.
Hey, Robin.
Hey.
Is Robin here? Hey, Robin.
Hey, waving to you guys. How are ya?
Good. How's it going? How's your wall?
How's my wall?
Yeah, that's what you're showing us right now, right? It's your wall.
Oh, okay. I need to... Okay.
Robin?
Yes.
Guys, I really hate to do this, but some shit just came up. I absolutely have to go.
Go.
Oh,
dude, I'm really, really fucking sorry, but I don't want to do this.
Not good enough, you motherfucker.
Robin's the new Ron. Get out of here, Ron.
I'm really sorry, guys. I'll explain later, dude.
You better be a good explanation.
You guys have a good evening.
Bye. Let
the doorknob hit you on the way out, dude.
Yeah. Ruin the show again.
Once again.
Can I ask a kind of question pertaining to much of the rest of the show? Do you have anything you'd like to say to the writer's muse?
Yeah.
Oh, isn't she just the most interesting person anyone's ever met?
Very interesting.
And you know what? Okay, I have told you guys that I've been the victim I can't say I'm a victim because I walked into it with my eyes open. But okay, here's this woman of a certain age. I don't know if it's her medical condition, but she looks kind of sort of close to my age. And I see her doing what I did only like 3D.
Right?
Yeah.
She's sucked in only like I have no words.
Robin, the way I see it is, I think you've got a lot of insight into this, and I see you as attempting to nurture, and I see the other lady as being more protective than that. It's like den mother for these guys.
I didn't go through any time of ever defending Eric. I see her just staunchly defending him, and I can't figure this out.
No, she can't answer a single question, and now she's attacking Patrick Butterfield, which is just goddamn reprehensible. Oh, that somebody would fucking call him a liar after all of the shit that he's gone through. All the shit that he's kept bottled inside for years. And then there's other sock accounts now coming out to accuse him of other shit. So it's like, what the fuck is your problem? You're really going to sit there and continue to victimize this person who's already been physiologically and psychologically abused? You're just going to continue to victimize this person for someone who's obviously a goddamn piece of shit? Like, there's no question that she knows that Patrick's a piece of garbage, and she accepts it, and she wants to defend it.
What do you think about that, Robin?
She had mentioned in many of her comments that she did not need to bother watching our stuff that we produced. And so her opinion that she's putting out there is formulated on... she didn't even watch us. She didn't even really hear our stories. She didn't need to. So she's making this assessment.
Yeah, she called Patrick Butterfield a liar. Like, you have some goddamn nerve. I mean,
but she has said, and I take this as a fact, that she's watched all of Patrick's videos, which means she's seen the same reprehensible, irresponsible behavior that we have, but have reached exactly the opposite conclusion. I mean, we're talking about the two Vitalis' parents, Channel and Vitali, the various ones where they appeared together with that hideously uncomfortable dynamic. The whole thing, opiate withdrawal, the men in black, the CIA, the multiple death threats, Wiley. The whole smash. She's seen the whole thing.
And I'm wondering, do you all know when she came on the scene? Do you know sort of that window where she came on the scene with Patrick?
I'm pretty sure she's been there since before we ever showed up. So.
Really? Because I don't remember her my following Patrick, because you guys know I've just stuck with him.
She may very well have never had any real adversity to Patrick before us. I mean, I could be wrong about that, but
I don't remember.
It's like it's a new thing to him to have people directly call him out for his fucking lies.
Yeah. I mean, what I've found is the people who tend to stand up for him are people who, like me at the beginning, felt sympathy for the guy and felt kind of pain he was going through, because we've all been in disturbed situations. But most of those people do it from a position of not being familiar with his range of affect.
Yeah, like, they all turn on him eventually.
Yeah.
So,
I've been
accused recently, and this is hilarious to me, of posting the link to my video about psychiatric care and Patrick's opinion of it, because I want to get views from Patrick's three supporters.
Yeah, all three of them.
Yeah.
And two of them might be a sock.
Yeah. And my attitude to that is, if you think that making content and appearing on stuff for views, you really don't know me very well at all.
I think, Patrick, I think the Invisible Prophets may very well be a sock.
I think the writing was a little too coherent for our friend, but who knows?
Could be Josh Luxor.
You know what? I was just going to mention that. Joshua had many, many socks, and he always used to comment on PJC, and I kind of nailed him. I know a couple of them. He has disappeared.
Yeah, he doesn't say shit anymore because he knows he's in trouble. So he won't mention a fucking word. He won't put himself in the spotlight at all.
He always used to be on it. He was always so on it.
Dude, the guy threatened me so many times that he was going to shut me down. And then now that I actually have something on his crazy ass, I don't hear a goddamn word.
I had a big threat from him.
What's that?
Hi.
Okay, I'll repeat myself since we're all stumbling. I had a big threat from Joshua, too.
Really? Why don't you share with us?
After Patrick did that thing to me on the internet and we disappeared from each other, I made these sock accounts. I may be one of them right now. And I commented many times on Patrick's videos, and then they started targeting me, and Joshua said, I have the ISP address. I will find them. And, you know, of course, it scared the shit out of me because, you know, what did I know? I know now it was bullshit.
You know what? Josh feels very empowered because his father is quite wealthy.
He
can do whatever the fuck he wants. But Joshua, you can't break the goddamn law, bitch. I don't care how rich your dad is. And I don't care what kind of favors he can call in. You're going to be caught for breaking the law, you stupid bastard. So you should be scared because you have every goddamn reason to be. So anyway, sorry.
Yeah, well, he's gone.
No, he's not gone. He's watching every goddamn move that's made. And he's
okay, hashtag waves at Adam.
Hashtag what?
Waves at Adam.
Hey, Adam.
Yo.
How's it going, buddy? Why don't you say a goddamn word? You had so much to say when you were threatening to destroy me with iPredator, but you don't have a goddamn word to say now. Now that I've accused you of various fucking horrible crimes. So why don't you just come out and speak your goddamn mind?
Yeah, Highness. Yeah.
Waiting. Hashtag bitch.
Tapping my foot.
We won't see shit. This piece of shit knows that he's fucking busted. He's going to keep his mouth shut.
Yeah.
You know what? You can keep your mouth shut, bitch. But you can't escape your destiny.
Yeah, so way back, Omni, I told you that I thought he had this wood for Patrick.
Yeah, I think he's totally gay. I don't care what he says.
Oh, no, there was something there.
Who would have wood for Patrick? He looks like a goddamn freak.
Now he does. Yeah, ew.
He always did.
He used to be cute. You know, he sucked me in.
I don't see it.
Yeah, not now. But, you know, he sent me those naked vids, so, you know.
Yeah, we have naked videos of Patrick, everyone. If that doesn't make you want to vomit, I don't know what could.
Yeah, it made my hormones pack their bags and move back in, you know?
So the lady that Patrick is sucking cash off of, he decides to send her fucking naked pictures. Delilah, from what I understand, the penis isn't your favorite object, right?
Yeah, especially not these days. You know, I'm this really old fucking woman, you know. Please.
But Patrick will take
it away.
I love your voice and how you curse. It's so wonderful.
Fun time.
Yeah, well, okay, Doc, I can tell you, I love your voice as well. Even though I have to say, you're the age of my youngest daughter, but baby.
If you're going to invite me over for dinner.
What do you like? I'm good at New England boiled dinner.
No, I'm all good. Maybe one day.
Yeah, okay. Maybe we'll meet up at Starbucks.
Oh, yeah, around the corner. Sure, okay.
Yeah, you can buy me a Venti or a Grande. I never get it straight because, you know, I'm old. I don't speak Starbucks.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you something. I'm old, too, relative to Starbucks.
I know.
But you know what?
Yeah.
I've never been arrested in Starbucks.
Me neither, but one of our friends has. Have they not?
I believe so, yeah, for criminal use of a credit card.
A credit card, yeah. And he said he was arrested because he was just being a shaman.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm glad it wasn't one of the Starbucks cards I sent him. Well, thanks, Omni, for mentioning that before.
Michael, are you with us?
He's taking a whiz.
I suspect so. Yeah. I've enjoyed what I think is valuable insight on the writer's muse. But as soon as she started to say to me that she wasn't willing to answer any questions or rebut any of the, I think, quite clear and cogent arguments I have for having the position I have.
I read all of your bullet points, and she just went, nothing. You asked some really good questions, and she just bailed.
Yeah. And, you know, there are reasons for that, and she's invested in the guy, and fair enough. You know, I'm sure the reasons that she has make sense to her. It's just, she couldn't make them make sense to me, in large part because I thought she was being really quite evasive to the point of intellectual dishonesty in some of the approaches she was taking.
Yeah, but then just like trying to get any sense out of Patrick John Coleman, she has this big, huge card she throws down, so she can say anything she wants.
No,
and
she
if you call her on it, she throws that card down and you're dead.
She can throw the card down a million fucking times,
and she does.
You're a goddamn Charles Manson supporter, you don't have any fucking defense, so I don't care how many times you throw that goddamn card down. And we're not saying what it is out of respect for other people who have similar afflictions. But you can say it as many times as you fucking want. But it doesn't matter, because when you defend an evil piece of shit, then you're still an evil piece of shit. And I don't care what problems you have.
Bam. Here is my Amy brain.
Well, yeah. Fun times.
Yeah.
I drunkenly lost my cell phone. I don't know where it went.
I know, and you're really slurring. This is so cute.
Yeah. I'm just like, where did it go? It should be at least here, but where is it? It's not here. And I didn't move from this spot, so it should be clearly visible.
Okay.
I've got an observation here. Omni, drunk out of his mind, still makes much more sense and can construct much more advanced sentences than most of the guys we make fun of on their best day.
Oh, no.
What?
You nailed it. Absolutely. Carry on, Omni, my dear heart. And can you fall out of your chair like Ron does?
I don't know. I don't think I can. This is a very deep chair. In fact,
you rock it just right. Back it really hard.
He's melting.
I'm melting in a chair. I feel it may be time for our final fizzots, Ms. Other Fizzuckers.
I think so. I feel the clock running.
Yeah, it's clear Amy's not going to join us, and Patrick's not going to join us. So let's just wrap this shit up.
I love you so much.
Me too.
Robin, quick question before final thoughts. I raised a hypothesis earlier, and it's something I'm just interested in opinions on. Do you think people would be defending Patrick, the couple of people that are, if he had beaten the crap out of a young lady?
You know what? I think not. I think these people would be on board with him no matter what he did. I know you had mentioned that before. I heard that. And I, no. I think a couple of people would be on board with his, even if he was kicking a cat, they'd be on board.
Or raping the cat like C.W. Chancer.
Yeah, I didn't want to go there.
We'll go there. Don't worry.
Thank you. I love you.
I jumped into your final thoughts there. Sorry.
Well,
Robin?
No, I was answering a question. That wasn't my final thought. Carry on.
Yeah. Well, what are your final thoughts?
Me? Well, thank you for having me on again. This was great, you know, and I would love to do more on that that woman, maybe.
Danielle Agnew?
Ah.
Crazy purple-haired psychic?
Crazy purple-haired, yeah, okay.
Most important lesbian in music?
Yeah, okay.
We have videos.
Oh, you're talking about me?
We didn't get to her. Danielle Agnew. It's a whole long story. It's a whole thing.
Okay, well, we can continue the story at another time, dear. Do you need to go night?
I'm feeling super drunk, so I'm pretty close.
Okay, we'll tie it up rapidly then.
Well, Ian, do you have any fizzinal fizzos, Ms. Other Fizzucker?
It's been a really interesting week, and for the last couple of days,
very interesting.
Yeah, no one's threatened to kill me, and that's really, really good. And I've enjoyed the various exchanges I've had with people who either agree, and that's usually a short conversation, or disagree, and that's usually a longer one. But with regard to Writer's Muse, and I think the lady was also on that thread. I'm done. I hope you come back with, well, absurdities and very poorly constructed arguments, if any. So we'll have to agree to disagree, and I'm confident that my choice of friends is, well, perhaps better than having Patrick as my nearest and dearest.
But it'll still tug at your heartstrings, I'm sure. But you know what? I'll bet the writer's muse will come up with something tomorrow morning.
Oh, yeah.
She can post, she can make videos, she can comment, she can come on the show. It's all good.
Well,
it's all good.
I have a final thought. I'm very drunk.
Yeah.
Very, very drunk. Just like the writer's muse knew, because of her psychic powers.
You fucking drunk. Go piss in your pants and lay down.
She knows who I really am. Alright. Patrick, take a look at this drunk and know that it's the person who is very intent to destroy you. Okay?
And you are succeeding.
You're gonna lose, bitch. That's what happens when you're a dirty lawbreaker, okay? So, this drunk and the drunk's friends, I guess, are saying good night.
Good night, y'all.
Let me go have a sad evening. And I'm sad because of all of the evil pieces of shit who yet walk free in the world. So there you go. That's why I'm a drunk, everyone.
Good night, John boy.
Good night.
Good night, homeboy.
Yeah, and by the way, Ron, since you're not here,
Fuck you! Go to hell, Ron! You ruined this whole show! Can't even have a show of solidarity! Fuck you, bitch! Alright. Good night.
Good night.
Thanks.
Good night. Alright, I'm ending broadcast. Bye.